Hello.
Oh.
Hello.
Why do you always, right, recently when we've been starting things, you've gone, hello, like you're Danny.
Hello.
I keep meaning to comment on it.
He's calling me out of my shit.
Now is not the best time, but still.
No, that was a terrible time.
Anyway, hello.
Hello.
How is everyone? What?
Meet my shiny Rubik's Cube that I caught earlier today after catching no shinies on stream for like, what?
I was so
three
salty.
Pokemon streams, and then I got it first try this
morning.
Does
that mean you don't have it saved anymore?
No, I don't. You can't save it if you catch it. So
now I can't get one.
Laurie's just giving me a pack of fried food, so I'm alright with this.
I meant to mute my Switch and just turned it to full volume, so whoops.
So today we are doing some more of the Dynamax raids.
Are you not going in?
Well, I want to show everyone how slow my Stack Attacker walks. Look how slow and chunky he is!
Because I kind of thought he would run after you.
Nah, he's so slow. Been so loose lately, I haven't been able to come to this room, but now here you are. We're glad to have you back.
Thank you for coming back. How are you doing?
Hello, how are you?
What have you been up to?
Also, Stack Attacker.
Life is weird right now, so don't worry. Hey, Happy!
Hey, Happy!
Doing?
Do you like my
Does this mean we're getting a Ramsay hello in a minute?
Right. So, as per normal, we are doing some... You're not actually here. Very confusing.
It's illegal.
We're doing some more of our Dynamax adventures. So we are. It is going to be open raids as normal. Today we are grinding for Tapu Fini. That's if you don't know this one, the one above me right here. I love
Wait,
it.
Wait, what's above me? Is
Oopsie.
That Oopsie? Yeah.
Because you really like it.
Yeah.
Good.
Oh, I like shiny.
It's Jay's bedtime. You gotta go dunk. Bath time. You gotta dunk the boy.
Gotta go dunk the boy.
Dunk the boy.
If that is a real life baby, not just weirdness.
Yeah, it's a real life baby. Don't worry. I love
that you
just came in.
Lurked good.
In. Dabs in, but in Animal Crossing. Dabs in Animal Crossing is my favourite language.
I feel like that's not the right game. So, we'll give you a couple of minutes because we know there's a couple of people in here that might want to join. And there's a couple of people we're expecting who aren't here yet. So, we'll chat some shit for a couple of minutes and then we'll start a lobby.
Silent spin. Yeah, so we're going to be hunting down Shiny Tapu Fini today. And hopefully, finally, we'll get... You do have Blacephalon!
I said I did!
Jesus Christ!
I said I did!
Can we rename the stream?
He wants to shiny hunt Blacephalon because it's weird.
So for people who don't know the Ultra Beasts, which are probably like the least known set of legendary Pokemon.
He's a weird like...
Well, he's on the overlay. He's the one above the Instagram logo. So he's bottom, at the very bottom row next to Zekrom.
He's right in the middle of
the white clowny thing. And I fucking love it.
I hate it. It's awful. I like Xerneas. Very bottom left.
Yeah. Apparently Blacephalon is used in doubles. But only doubles. Blacephalon. I say Blaze Blaceph. The gay rights Pokemon. Yeah, the gay rights Pokemon.
Why is he the gay rights Pokemon?
Have you looked at him recently?
Okay.
He's cute.
So, if any of you do want to join, we added a new thing. I'm assuming you actually did it. You can type !! raid.
It's in the title of the video, so
in
apparently.
Chat, and you can get the code we're going to use.
He definitely takes part in Pride.
Octo!
Hello, Bocto!
How you doing?
Bocto. I call him Bocto.
Bocto. So, we are going to get one set up in just a sec when we have. Feel free to hop in.
I'll get it going. 8335300.
There we go.
Not
actually, how you doing,
Octo? You're actually doing it. You just want to see if it works.
Oh, well, thank you for testing it for us.
I love it.
Like, I love Octo and Mam were straight on it.
Oh, yeah. We knew that would be trying to fix technology stuff. Almost done. I have my fingers crossed for you.
Oh, I hope you sort it out this time.
I have every crossable part of myself crossed.
Love to you too.
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna hop in then.
So guys, lobby's open.
I will also be jumping in these raids. If it starts getting real busy, I'll stop jumping in as much to give more space for people. But for now, I'm freaking
You're gonna
joining.
Join Canon? Nice.
Awesome.
So there is a high chance. There you are. Got before the
got
other
in
streamer.
Before me.
That's hilarious.
Nice.
There's a chance that for the first... Yeah, we... I can see.
I mean, yeah.
there is a chance that after the first, like for the first lobby, so we won't have a full one.
Yeah,
but we're
sometimes
hoping
at the start of these streams, we end up having one NPC with us for
but
a little bit.
But to be fair, if it's an NPC, we get to yell at them incessantly, and it's always fun to yell at Cassandra or whoever it is you get.
We've had a couple of people IRL messages and go, I will be there late. So.
Yeah. Then comes the awkward part where we sit and wait for like 2 minutes.
Right.
Fucking Cassandra.
What's wrong with Cassandra?
It's just she it's that we were playing with some friends in a casual one once, and we had one of them, I can't remember what Pokemon they were using. But it was the speed swapper.
Oh my god, right, me, Luke and Andy were playing, and I was Mopiko. It's It did a speed swap with Andy once.
What was the Pokemon?
I can't remember what Andy was. But it speed swapped with me every turn. Every turn, right. Because Morpeko's speed changes every turn. So it was like, oh, I could do it again.
It was such a weird thing it was doing because so Morpeko has two forms, right? Pokemon is every second turn
Angie
changes
or
type.
Happy.
Angie or happy. And then 115, cool. Check how much longer we had. And then the way it worked was the Pokemon was going skill like speed swap because you're faster than me. So taking speed and faster. But then because the form changed every turn, Betty was always going faster, so it always swapped. So we just were Pokemon demos.
Yeah,
swap.
We may as well have just had three Pokemon. It was so stupid.
It was so funny. And how did I not say it right? Because it's Dora, so it's fucking.
Yeah, you have to hold that G.
You have to hold it. She's gonna feel called out.
That's fine.
In a second, she's gonna go, mate.
If she doesn't see nice, though, she'll call you hon.
Yeah. You go too high. It's a lowing. It's fucking. Fucking mate. Right.
So, I'm gonna give it to right till the end.
Why'd you do this to me?
Why not? I forgot what I was gonna say now. Thank you. Oh yeah, I love that all the teachers have been like, all of the doodles on everything are Among Us. Mm-hmm. Little Among Us beans.
Aura wheel changes depending on form. Yellow color is electric and the black is dark is yeah.
Yeah. But he was getting speedy and just this is you.
Oh, yeah, we're doing thingy. So yeah.
So what do we need?
We want electricity, poison, grass. Is there anything else that you're missing, Luke? Because Tapu Fini is a good defensive
type. Hang on, double Stunfisk.
Double Stunfisk!
But different colours.
Yeah, one is Galarian Stunfisk, one is regular Stunfisk.
Oh, I don't think I knew Galarian Stunfisk was a thing. Because who gives a shit about Stunfisk?
Oh my lord,
no
double Stunfisk. I like Stunfisk. I had a friend who was really in Stunfisk, so we probably go left path, because we can get grass type, then poison with item, and then I guess the Skarmory at the end of everything's fine, but
alright. He's saying left, go grass.
Which TW? I will narrate as we go. I'll try to as we go, like make sure yelling early.
He yells at everyone for which way to go. Don't worry.
This is my least favorite thing about raids. Also, guys, don't forget the Pokemon scream when they appear. So, hod your ears.
One boy doodled an Among Us bean on a desk, and it stained the desk. You're just gonna be haunted by those little beans.
There's the screaming boy.
Leggy.
I like Serena.
Kinky boots.
Serena and... Okay, you have fire moving Scuntank. Yeah, you should have flamethrower. I'll be fine for Dynamaxing this one for the poison.
Them legs.
Because we should have... Yeah, Sludge Bomb.
I am just not so very effective.
Is it going to be worth it? Yeah, I can probably just G-Max this and Big Ooze. Increases every team special. Yeah, let's go for it.
Also, we've got Pionia with us. That's the NPC.
We got Pionia? Mm. Oh, have we?
Yeah.
Oh, I must have took this one. Okay, so apparently our mic is quieter than the screaming, so we'll lower it down a little bit.
Yeah, we'll take the game sounds down a bit. Thank you.
We have Burning Jalousy. Nice.
Hey, Glacier Eyes, how you doing? Yeah, apparently...
I'm walking away for a second.
The Pokemon screaming is extremely loud today.
It's always had a...
And I'm sorry, because Mam complains about this every time. We didn't realise, because we don't play with it... We don't play with Pokemon very loud on anyway, because we're usually watching something or doing something else, or talking to people, or whatever.
I play it a lot while I'm working.
Or streaming. But we did play it at Andy's, and we were like, holy shit, they do screm, though. They really do yell.
I've been telling you for weeks. The problem is, this game doesn't have, like volume sliders, right? So I can't just turn down the
best
sound effects.
Friends.
All I can do is turn down all the sound. Yeah, Daughter of the Man we had to battle. Yes.
But you do? What?
I do? It's fine. We've turned it down a little bit there.
As I say, we found out, because we were like, oh, okay, we'll turn the game sound down a bit, and then it was never quite enough. And as I say, then we went to Andy's and he had the TV on quite loud. We were like, holy shit, they do fucking scream though.
Yeah, it was the first time we heard it. Once again, missed you guys.
This
I'm coming at you live from work.
I love that you watch us from work.
Well, it's really funny because I watch people from work. Like, I watch this particularly. I watch G-Max Raids while I'm working. you've Sword Physical with the DLC and Shield Digital with DLC with it together. Oh, that's nice. We have a copy of both in flat. I originally bought Shield when I first got the game with the Steelbook edition. Can't believe I gave you my Steelbook.
Well, it's ours.
It's ours.
It's not like it went anywhere.
I know. So I bought Shield with it, and then when she bought her Switch after me, she'd been playing Shield on my Switch.
Yeah, I'd been playing Shield, but...
So she was halfway through her save.
The bundle I found, which was the cheapest, was get a Switch. I don't want that.
I'm just keeping this wheezing the whole way through.
It was get a Switch with one of the new Pokemon games, right? And I could pick whether it was Sword or Shield, and I said, there's no point us both having Shield...
Lying.
Oh yeah, go left. There's no point in us both having Shield, so why don't I buy Sword so we can play through that? But I still want my game, so can we transfer my save to my Switch? And then it just happens that I just use Shield all the time, so I kind of bought him Sword and he gave me Shield.
Yeah, that was the play. Because I was like, I'll just replay the games, but I don't want to. I don't know. I didn't want to like. Have two guys the same one flat. It was like
it just seemed daft to have two of the same game.
There you go, that's our puzzle.
Got fourth Sagittarius star. God damn you, I didn't get any.
You work in off settings, so you have plenty of freedom for this kind of stuff. That's fair, I work from home at the moment, so I work at a call center most of the time, so like when I'm not working from home, I can't do it. But now I'm working from home, I have a lot of freedom in what I'm doing with these sort of things.
Yeah.
So I usually keep a little Switch on. I usually keep my Switch on my desk, and I also... what's the word? I usually put a stream on muted in the background. Just watch it. I love to comment on them, being like, hi there, you can't respond back to me. I can't hear you. But I like what you're doing. It's always fun.
Yeah.
I had a moment because I caught my Stack Attack at the end. I was watching someone. I was trying to win. I can't. I've been lurking, by the way, this entire time. I just got a shiny Stack Attack and I just want someone to be proud of me because everyone else was sleeping or at work.
Yeah, I was leaving. I got no sleep last night, so I ended up having a really late morning. I nearly suffocated him in his sleep.
I snore.
He was a snory boy last night.
God.
It was less the snoring, it was that you rolled over and did it right in my ear, and I was like, don't, I'm triggered.
Sleepy.
Love you.
Oh, you do pretty much admin work for insurance claims processing agency.
Oh.
Fair, I work for a bank, so.
Huh.
I work for a bank, and by work for a bank, I mean I want to slap the bank constantly.
Oh.
Dan, I am a screamer. Can I call this a job yet?
Yeah, I mean, we literally worked it out. We were like, well, we do each work a part-time job on this.
Yeah, so just giving our hours.
We don't earn enough for it to qualify as that, but that's fine. We're getting there. We're still growing.
We're gonna feed our 12 children.
Never.
Never.
but we both do over 20 hours a week.
Sorry.
On streaming stuff. So, because we do like 16 hours minimum just streaming.
We want to fight the fairy, but not take it, because the fairy is the easiest one for us to kill.
Okay.
And then we're fine for the legendary, because actually you're the one who's weak. You will struggle against the legendary because you're weak to water.
That's fine.
But you have super effective against it because you're electric.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot what I was saying. There's been a problem recently. I keep doing this.
If I get a shiny one of these, I mean, it's probably going to you, isn't it?
Why?
I've already got one.
I know, but... What? Azumarill?
Yeah, I've got a shiny Azumarill.
Why? Yeah.
Think it has Sap Zipper? I don't know. They don't have... They definitely don't have Power Up. So PC made a good move. Fair. There's a first time for everything, the PC making a good decision.
Right.
I hate the PCs in this. They often will just do the world's most dumb boy plays. I'm really into it. Did I just see that TSP has gone to our other group chat to say that?
Wait, yeah.
I forgot it will only work if Weezing goes...
Wait. Flat!
It does?
So flat!
If Weezing does what? If Weezing does what?
Goes first.
Yeah, sap separate, you remember. Cool. It's good to know. Oh, nice! It landed the hypnosis!
Well... This is easy.
Peony's got our backs. Spray.
You quite like Skuntank, don't you?
Skuntank is one of my favourite Pokemon aesthetically. I used one in my very first playthrough of Diamond and Pearl. I love them. Such bomb!
See, Skuntank's the sort of Pokemon I think I should like more, but I don't really like it.
I love Stunfisk's stupid face.
Oh my god, yeet, goodbye. You're dead. One turn.
That's so good. If Weezing does, if Weezing dies, Sapsap will work. That's fair. Peony is no Cassandra. Thank God. Peony's good. I like it.
I haven't really been into Pokemon since Heart Gold, Soul Silver.
To be fair, though, those are good ones to leave it on. Like Heart Gold, Soul Silver, are absolute fan favorites.
Fair.
And they're so good.
So I know little of what you guys are talking about. So I only really know some of the newest Pokemon stuff. So all the older stuff, yeah. I have to turn to Luke and go, what?
Yeah. You know your way around this game and such. Since Weezing has neutralizing gas, negates all abilities until it dies. Oh, of course I do.
I'm also just extremely lazy in that I don't really need to learn anything about Pokemon because I could just turn to the Encyclopedia of Pokemon over here. So I should know more than I do, but because I don't have to, I don't bother. Let's go. Pikachu was my last. I think that's me tapped out of the series, which is a little bit sad.
I really like Let's Go Pikachu. I won't be honest. Let's Go Pikachu is such a nice casual game. I definitely want more games that are. Why would you, honey?
Why did you trade
the Haunter? I hate you, Pionia.
It's Cassandra again.
It's Cassandra. She's turned full Cassandra.
I mean, I love Pokemon Go, but it doesn't really help you learn much about Pokemon, especially in the early days. It was just catch what you see around you.
My curiosity, ma'am, if you're saying tapped out but you love Let's Go Pikachu, if they release a second Let's Go game, would you be into that and would you get that? Because I've been saying I would love another Let's Go. I think that they should do a Call of Duty thing and cycle, where Call of Duty split its development because it was getting really stale because the one company was just churning out the same game over and over. They decided what they'd do was they would split it between two developers and they would do two mainline titles a year, right?
Yeah.
One from Treyarch, one from Infinity Ward.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's right. I would love to see Pokemon do that with and split it between people who made Let's Go and the people who make the mainline games, because a lot of people say these games are rushed right now. That's a hard, unsure, fair. I was just curious, because I will buy a second Let's Go game in a heartbeat, right? I've been saying they should do Let's Go Togepi and Let's Go whatever the other one is, but it's definitely Togepi.
This was not as tanky a thing as I thought, so I set up Electric Terrain for myself. I don't think I needed to.
Fair. That's like your wife and you enjoy when it comes to wrestling. She enjoys it, but she doesn't care to learn anything about it because she can just ask me.
Yeah, it's such a thing. I love Pokemon and I've definitely learned bits and bobs. But it's kind of like I said to Luca a little while ago, I kind of don't have to make the effort because he's just here.
Pokemon is definitely.
And also, yeah, he does that with Drag Race. I'll just tell him everything.
I'll be like, wait, who's that? I wish you knew wrestling. That's fair. She said
that's
I wish
hilarious.
Knew less about wrestling. For Drag Race, I've learned a fair amount, but I just like to be what's this?
Sorry about lady sponsors.
Oh,
it's technically
don't
working.
Worry.
No, don't worry at all. We'll just assume it's delayed.
TSP just, I know nothing about anything. I mean, both.
Excuse me, don't just take out her diddly squat.
She goes diddly squat about both. Yeah, but it's our first death and the thing's at half health. It's dead.
Yeah.
We've got this raid pretty well because... even though we don't have any healing, so long as it doesn't surf too often, it's good to know that it has surf given that we're
going
around.
It's nearly dead.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't worry.
How dare you take out my diddly squat?
Let's Go Pikachu, in hindsight, is a really nice way to bookend my relationship with Pokemon.
Do you know what? That's
fair. Since many our age, my first was yellow.
Cool. My first was red and blue and then yellow, but...
My dog!
Fighto! Nice. It's because we yelled Fighto. Special time.
Bye. My first mainline Pokemon game was Pokemon Shield.
I know. How am I dating? I mean, I have played
The problem was, people just weren't into handheld consoles when I was a kid.
No, that's fair.
I know we were a kid at the same time, which is where I grew up.
Mm-hmm.
So it never became a thing.
Right. Same for TSP. I played the first one. I'd say my first game that I remember... super duper getting into was Ruby and Sapphire, right? It was the age where it became special level obsession for me. I've played every single one first. Your first was Japanese Green with a Japanese Game Boy from a flea market for $40 for your fourth birthday.
That's so cool.
Like, way to just come in and flex. Like, that's a drop. Like, for most people be like, oh yeah, my first red and blue year is like, nah. Green. Like, wow, that's cool. Yellow? Nah. Black? Nah. No shinies here.
No shinies here either.
Still checking because I don't know what color shiny Serena is. That sucks.
I don't know what color shiny Serena is. And it seems like one of the ones where they go, it's very slightly different.
I mean, the number of Pokemon that do that with shiny sprites. Oh, don't worry. I'm joking. I think it's really cool.
It was the thing.
Unless I'm sorry, I just got shiny Tapu Fini first try.
Please stop yelling. It was the thing with my friends. I just wasn't bothered saving money for a handheld.
Fair.
Yeah. I was also just like by far the youngest of like all of my cousins. Because, like, there was just no one of my equivalent, so my mum and dad didn't really know about handheld consoles. Oh, she's purple.
Shiny Serena's purple and yellow.
That's quite nice.
Are either of us wrestling fans? Unfortunately not.
I'm sorry, we're not.
And then we changed Shiny Gengar to white. Yeah, they did.
No Shiny. Aww. Fair enough. Right, let's go.
1 second, I need to actually finish this menu. Because I need to make sure I save it. Because it will potentially happen that I accidentally delete the Tapu Fini. This has happened to me twice now where I've deleted the Tapu Fini. You couldn't catch because of the... You already had Tapu Fini. That sucks. I have been so stingy on taking legendaries because I'm trying to avoid them.
Did you see that pop up?
No.
Oh, never mind.
What happened?
I've got something in a basket we said we were going to order earlier and we never did. Oh. It's a present for someone. Yeah. Anyway, sorry.
we'll finish our shopping later.
I just saw it pop up. It was like, don't forget, I'm in your basket.
Right.
Piss off.
Let's go. We will get a shiny fish today. So, the reason we're doing Tapu Fini is because that's one of the competitive ones that's going to be, apparently it's going to be pretty decent for this, particular set. Like...
Well, you've gone basic enough because I know of The Undertaker.
I know of... I had, when I was, primary school, so I was less than 10.
Oh, by the way, if you want to join !raid to get the code,
it's also on screen in the over
it
there.
Is also in the screen over, but there. we just thought we'd add more accessibility. I've just whacked the the mic, sorry. Oh, I lie, I had a question mark handheld.
I love you have a portable PlayStation, a portable PlayStation 1 that counts.
A PSP?
No, she has a portable PlayStation 1.
What do you mean?
She has a portable PlayStation 1.
What do you mean? What is that?
It's a PS1 with an inbuilt screen.
I didn't know that exists.
I wasn't considering that. I had no idea that happened. I just yelled to a man in the box to confirm. He didn't tell me. We'll see. Well, tactical screen.
He didn't tell me because we'll see if he's really retired, I think is the, the thing there. Also, Kana, if you do want to hop back in for another one, go for it.
We do not limit number of people. We only limit if there are people queuing to get in raids and such. One of these days, we'll create a queue system and everything.
Also, if anyone super wants anything else,
we will happily do other raids.
Yeah, we will do some other ones as well. But Luke has just decided this is the shiny.
Every time
we
need filler, we're going to probably do a Tapu Fini.
Yeah.
But for example, we could do a Blacephalon because
it's got an attachable screen.
Yeah.
I didn't even know that existed. So when I kept saying a what and you just kept repeating yourself, you didn't think.
I didn't know it was attachable until she said that.
I know you didn't. That's got nothing to do with it. When I kept repeating what you said and then said a what, you didn't think to explain rather than just repeat it, is where I was going.
Thought all the words made perfect sense in combination.
But
it's all right.
He's not giving in, is he? I'm trying to find the handle I was thinking about, but it literally has no title.
I am so into it.
What? I did have a Game Boy Color at one point that I think I got off of a cousin, but literally had 2 games on it, never used it.
I love this. Sorry, I have to admit, falsehood, my official stance was I wish I knew less about wrestling, but I have to admit, I now stand Abaddon from AEW. I care now and I never meant to. Googling all sorts of 90s handheld with 9 games.
Oh, was it one of those ones that only had built-in games?
Must be. Right, I guess we're going for a what?
Well, I guess it's just us then.
I guess we're doing a twofer.
We can always exit out and queue again. Oh, we just ready. Going for it.
All right. I want my shinies. The more raids we do, the more likely we are going to get a shiny today, and I want one so bad. AEW. He's here!
I love you.
These are all bad.
Yeah, these are all awful.
Like, they are literally all weak to the final boss.
Well, then I shall swap out on the way, hopefully.
And the Porygon was the only good option.
Yeah, well, they never take the good option.
They never take the good option. They live to upset you. You love AEW. You stan Chris Jericho. Always have.
They are words.
I didn't... They are words and names! Right, don't know. It's all bad. All the way. Let's go, girls. We actually want the left. We want the top left. Because it's a... The best thing I can find for us is a... Quillfish, because it's water poison.
Oh, Jesus, a quillfish. We're not wrestling.
Also, fuck McMahon. I know about McMahon. Apparently, he's an absolute twat.
McMahon,
I thought.
Is that how do you say it?
McMahon, I think.
I thought the H is silent. Oh! Well, a big detail!
It's copying me!
Well, yeah, you're the leader of the raid.
Man, we had a conversation about this big friendly boy recently. Or like one of the last times we did it, you were like, who is this friend?
I've got a super effective, by the way. Oh.
Oh, I set up a light screen.
Fair. Just in case you wanted to do the instruct.
Yeah, for real. The WWE creative shit the bed years ago. I follow... The only thing I know about anything to do with wrestling is that a YouTube reviewer, Jim Sterling, has a wrestling persona and tweets a fair amount about wrestling. So occasionally I see a little bit and I'm like... Oh, interesting but awful.
Before meeting your friend group, I didn't know of anyone that liked wrestling.
And now you know one. Right.
Well, no. Three. Well, there's Mom Kieran.
Yeah.
And now Glacier Eyes.
Oh, yeah. Fair.
Bitch.
It's also pronounced McMahon. Oh, I thought it was pronounced McMahon, but apparently it's pronounced McMahon.
Fuck you! Ha ha!
There's not that much emphasis on the.
Yeah, McMahon. You just kind of make it. You just kind of blend. You make it slightly longer than McMahon.
McMahon. McMahon. Wait, is Glacier Eye somewhere I know? I don't think so.
No.
But
like, it's still a conversation that we are having with a real person that likes wrestling.
Yeah.
And I.
She counts that apparently. I love that.
Glacier Eyes, don't worry about it.
We're all
sorry.
Being stupid.
We're sorry that our mod is terrifying you.
No, well, you did say... I don't know, do you know me? Maybe we do, maybe we don't.
Yes, because Mam and Kieran are in the... I can't with anyone today. Because Mam and Kieran are in the friend group, and they were the first people...
I just G-maxed. I would pay attention. I've been instructing you and you're G-maxed. It doesn't work on G-max, everyone.
Well, yeah, that'd be really broken.
Hey, Dad Dam.
Hey, Dad Dam.
Maybe we're besties, perhaps.
Maybe we are besties. Oh.
Lovers.
You have a wife!
You have a wife and she has a husband. Not a husband, but it might as well be.
Yeah. TSP basically has a husband.
Yeah. TSP basically has a wife.
Can we buy mine a really nice apron?
TSP, I'm married? Dope.
No!
I do effectively nothing for Kieran to like.
No, hey, we meant you, Glacier Eyes, being married, not...
No, I meant Dora.
We meant both, but the original comment. Please stop making it harder!
Sorry, I love you so much.
Oh my god, I quit.
How did this start? Disaster struck tonight in the 405.
Kieran's just a destructive force. So I have a genuine question.
Ooh.
And this is probably going to cross as shady. I don't mean it to.
Oh, yes. This will be good.
But why do you like wrestling? The people in chat who like wrestling. What is it that you like about it?
So, from what I hear, it's because it's ridiculous, right? Because it's all fake. It's all just entertaining beat 'em up. Like,
sorry, I'm laughing at TSP. Close your eyes now together and in love. Keep up.
I don't!
Alright, I know two people.
Boss married Teresa's.
Yeah. That's so cute.
I love that we've sowed a good amount of destruction. If Andy was here, his best friend would have arrived and he would be able to take his ditto and been happy. But instead, he's not here. He's a loser.
We all wanted the ditto, apparently.
Right, I love it for the creativity and storytelling. And then Mab's like...
F?
Oh, apparently I'm not allowed to say it's fake. Apparently that's illegal to say that the fake thing is fake.
I love it.
Let's get the egg, friend. Because if the allies take it, there's a chance we get healing. Wait. Left.
Oh, he just yells. It's scripted / staged.
Do you know, that is fair. And I will accept that.
That doesn't mean it's fake because it's not trying to sell itself as being otherwise.
No, like, kids might believe that it's real. But like, scripted / staged definitely makes sense. It's definitely what it is.
But I kind of like that. I love it for the creativity and storytelling. That's fair enough. Like, I guess it can be really dramatic. And like, you can get really hyped. Like, ooh, you know? Mm-hmm. I can understand those kind of bits about it. It's not a sport. It's sports entertainment. Okay, so different lives of your SOs IRL with each other now?
But I'm sorry, your statement, it's sports entertainment. That's a paradox. Because sports is not entertainment.
Oh, I do nothing. I'm going to heal because of the Doug Trio.
Yeah, sure. Let's go. We're getting double heals, boys.
Really?
Yeah. It's actually beneficial to us to get a double heal. It didn't work because I'm faster than you. Well, great.
That's stupid.
Why have we gone from relationships to sports? Keep on then, damn. It's wrestling. It's watching burly men hug and kiss. And burly women.
You're making assumptions.
You healed the enemy chance, I think. Are you where heal pulse is single target and you have to choose which one you're aiming at? Or did you just press A on repeat?
Well, heal pulse sounds like it would be AoE!
Okay. Oh yeah, if you ever get curious, you should give Chris Jericho's podcast a listen. He gives a lot of insight behind the curtain. That's fair. Have we had the talk with Octo? Yay. He taught me about the birds and the bees recently.
We're in negotiations.
Negotiations.
We're in negotiations.
And where did it target?
Shut up. Look, it sounds like it'd be AoE.
Octo taught you to fuck?
Yep.
Alpangs.
Alpangs, that was... excellent timing.
Oh, Alpang's had a bad word. He also talks about music because he's also the frontman for a band called Fozzy.
Hey, are you attacking?
Yeah, I'm gonna attack. I'm gonna go bang.
Can I helping hand you?
Yes, you can helping hand.
You're getting boosted for once. Normally, as Aran Guru, all he does is instruct.
Yeah, ban me. I can't do that.
Alpang said a bad word.
So you get half his viewers for him to be featured on stream. No, he'll probably keep his viewers and won't keep ours. We'll fight over the ones that like see both, watch both.
Yeah, well, this is the thing. I'm sure that, you know, everyone will still just watch their streamer. But it'll be good exposure for both. For the few people on our stream that don't already know Octo.
The three.
Yeah.
And also just like, it'll be fun because we like him. He's a good job, Doug Trio. You just half your health for nothing.
If you ever get curious, you give Chris Jericho's podcast listen. He gives a lot of insight behind the curtain. And he talks a lot about music since he's the frontman for a band called Fozzy. Cool. Hydrate, Binch. Hydrate.
I can't. I'm fidget spinning.
Hydrate.
Fidget spinning.
Hydrate. This is a threat.
The battlefield got weird. So the energy in the studio.
We have cherries and berries juice today.
Because
it does taste a little like
Haribo.
Yeah, it tastes a little like stale Haribo. I used to really like this juice, and I've really gone off it recently.
Well, saying things like it tastes like stale Haribo probably doesn't help you.
No.
Probably. Oh, look, I'm just playing Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Chancy is round. Yes, you are, sir. Yes, you are.
He is round. It's alright, I healed him. What?
You can't heal a Pokemon behind a substitute.
Oh, he put a fucking substitute
on. Aye, that's how he got that low in the first place.
Dick.
I think what we want, right?
I love being threatened to hydrate.
We attempt to let the LPC take it.
The LPC?
Apple juice, best juice. I don't like apple juice.
I love apple juice. Apple juice, best juice.
I don't like it.
I like... Oh, by the way, when I said juice, I mean like squash. Like diluting juice, but fresh apple juice, amazing. Fresh cherry juice is.
Fresh cherry juice exists. Cherry jam is a shout.
Yeah, it's called Cherry Good. And I really need. Oh, I'm gonna add some to our shop. We did a Tesco shop earlier. I'm so adding some cherry juice.
We actually kind of want to let Janet... We want to try and get Janet to take it.
I know.
Come on, Janet, I believe. Janet! Right, now we don't let Janet get away from it.
My dad had an award-winning doggo called Alfie that was Harry's granddad. Harry is the dog that I have a tattoo for on my foot.
What's blunder? Blunder policy doesn't matter. Evie Light doesn't matter. I guess I take the quick clocks. The rest of it's garbo. Like, normal gem does nothing. Muscle band does nothing. So... Quick Claw is kind of the only decent-ish thing, and we will water here.
Hydrate is what you're saying.
Yeah, we hydrate
cherry
on the...
juice is so good. I have a love-hate relationship with blueberry juice. Ooh.
The love part is it tastes good. The hate part is you can't drink it without thinking of Willy Wonka. Like, am I the only person that when anyone mentions blueberries, all I think about... It's all I think about.
It's Violet Beauregard, right?
Yeah,
it's only
so.
Violet. Kieran just made me watch Jericho's recent entrance with an audience. It's very sweet. Blueberry juice is the best mixer for vodka. What?
But I think it is Violet Beauregard because I often think... the reason I get confused, say her name, is because... I never want to get it mixed up between Violet Beauregard and Violet Baudelaire.
Oh, Baudelaire.
From the series Unfortunate Events.
I read the 7th book in the series Unfortunate Events first.
Which was the 7th?
The Crows.
Cool. It's the Village one. It's
the
Violet
Village.
Village.
Yeah, that's the first one I read. Me and my mum and dad. What?
Is that Valley or what?
Yeah, Battle Village is book 7.
I don't know if I'm going to do entire ones in order. Bad Beginning. The Menagerie.
We don't have them all here. We will have them all here when I bring my stuff up. Because 8 is the hospital one. We've really gone on our own tangent chat.
Bye, chat. You talk about wrestling for a while. I'll be back in a minute once I think about the entire series of Unfortunate Events.
I love those Unfortunate Events.
They're so
good. Me and my best friend when I was a kid, got really into them, and we would see like VFD everywhere and stuff like that.
Yeah, like the whole concept of VFD is so clever.
So the year I got that book, me, my mum and dad were all really, really ill with norovirus.
Wow.
And 7 was the newest book out, and my mum very much on Christmas Eve, we'd been ill for like a month. So she'd not done very much Christmas shopping because she'd been really ill, but she was starting to feel better. On Christmas Eve, very much just like went and ran around all the shops and just kind of picked up random shit. It was actually, she did a good job, to be honest. And one of those things was she was like, oh, this seems like the kind of book Beth would enjoy. Didn't realise it was the 7th in a series, but it's fine because then we got the other 6, so it made sense.
Let me catch up on chat quickly. So... hides the sharpness of vodka. Also, sorry about that massive tangent wrestling. It's something I'm very passionate about. Don't worry, always feel free to go on rant tangents about your passions.
Why would you mix wine and vodka together? Dead damn, that is a valid question. You only do that if you have a death wish.
Right, I'm going to go through the entire thing, but let me just quickly say, how to DLC. So, first things first, you need to get to the Crown Tundra. If you've bought the DLC, you'll be able to do that, no problem. What you need to do is do the intro of the game until you have received the wishing piece. And you're instructed to go back to the train station. When you go to the train station, you should be given a Tundra Pass that allows you to get to the Crown Tundra. Once you get to the Crown Tundra, you do one fight with an old man. And then you are able to get to the DLC section. So you need to play the game for a little bit. Should take you about 15 minutes, 20 minutes, and then you'll be able to catch up. Well, 15, 20 minutes if you rush.
Fair. Dead Damn followed up with, my family would kill you for mixing. It's not really a posh thing, Dead Damn, and your family only drink, like, wine, etc. as a fairly posh thing. TSP did it to get drunk fastest, yeah. Which is what you do when you're a student.
Do you have to win the fight? I think you may have to win the fight, but I believe the one with Thingy.
Hot.
Cobalt just... No, the one with Peony. I believe you have to win the fight, but I don't believe it's very difficult. I believe it scales to your level.
Yeah, I don't know if you have to win it. So, either way, Pip did. And she's barely played.
Yeah, that's true. And we have a friend who restarted, who made another save to do more DLC stuff. So we know it definitely works, in essence, right? I'm setting up a light screen this one because we need it.
Yeah.
Also, hey, Cobalt here!
Hey, Cobalt!
Get your butt in here, we're going fishing!
Mixing vodka, wine, and blueberry juice. Jesus. I think the appeal to wrestling is something like what attracts people to Dragon Eurovision. It's like high camp, high stakes, high melodrama. It's just an edgy flavour.
I get that. Also, you Glacier Eyes did say earlier you and your wife were watching the Netflix series of Series of Unfortunate Events. Finish it. It's so good. Like, I genuinely love that adaptation. I think it's really good.
It's pretty good.
I loved it.
Just have holy water or absinthe if you just want to be drunk. Holy water?
Well, the problem with holy water, though, right, is...
What?
The problem with holy water is it's actually the opposite. It gets you undrunk.
No.
Because it exorcises all the spirits from you.
What? Look, I am confusion tonight. Y'all are just saying random shit to me.
Are you...
Everyone has confused me this evening. What do you mean, holy water? It's just water! I have a level 7 skull bunny, pretty strong right now. Do you know how expensive absinthe is? Right. And get wine for a fiver and vodka for 10. And also, absinthe will kill you.
I perhaps have some Hungarian spirit called Binga, which is very good at getting drunk. Just drink Everclear.
What the heck is Everclear?
I don't drink!
Oh, Plinker is awful. I'm pretty sure my friend brought some to a house party once and we all hated it. We all did a shot of it, you know. But we hated it.
No, help the inflated one.
Yes, it is awful. Most alcohols that are intended to get you drunk quickly are awful. Let's be fair, right?
I don't know if I talked about the incident or not.
The incident? I hope this is an absinthe incident. Everclear is 90% proof? Jesus.
Luke will remember an incident where you got drunk stuck on a floor in Edinburgh.
It's extremely strong.
I don't remember this.
Hang on, what? Where was that bit?
TSP apparently got drunk stuck on a floor in Edinburgh.
My landlord popped by to continue being the best landlord. Okay. Can we have your landlord, please?
We would like a new one.
They're just ignoring us about shit.
Hey, Gerbil.
Hey, Gerbil. My dad used to make slow wine. Not slow as in the speed, as in the berry.
This was like second year of uni and you and Cobalt were getting ready to come around. Oh my god! Yes! The evening where we just started getting, like, so she was fucking fine, right? I want to preface this story by saying she was fine. Everything was fine. But we started getting texts to my phone just saying, Luke, help. Luke, help. I can't stand up. Luke, I'm in trouble. Luke, help. And I'm like, oh my god. And I go around my flat rallying everyone. I'm like, guys, you have a car. Dora, TSP's in Edinburgh. We need to help her. We need to do something about this. And then I get a photo from her friend just saying, like a selfie of her and Dora. And Dora's like, eh. And we're like, yeah, she's fine. She just absolutely smashed.
Thank you for following, King Kira. Welcome.
Oh, thank you so much.
He's just in the middle of yelling about a story. I said, Hlep, I'm stuck on the floor.
It was so badly typed as well.
Everclear can get up to 95%? Jesus, that's crazy.
Well.
And TSP, yeah, my landlord is selling a flat and came to offer us the furniture.
Oh, that's lovely.
Can we have it?
We need furniture.
TSP, if there's a sofa, please get us the sofa.
Please, we're sinking.
We need it. No problem at all. Thank you for being patient with us, King Kira. Are you wanting to hunt a Tapu Fini with us?
If you want in, we'll be doing another raid right after this one.
Well, yeah, we're just finishing this one. Soz, we stealing the sofa? Can we have your sofa? Anything! Give us your sofa!
Goodbye, my Aaron Guru. I love you.
There you go. So that'll be the raid code. We'll get one set up after this.
We use the exact same one every time because it's so much easier. It's all cool, no worries.
Oh, you're so chill.
You're so chill!
I have no shinies.
I'm sorry.
You were wondering how I did that so fast. I have Tapu Fini.
Nice.
So yeah, so Luke's playing on the screen. I've got my own Switch as well.
Nice sofa leather. We never want to get a leather one. We always want to get like at least faux leather.
Yeah, I wouldn't get a real leather one.
She veggie.
Yeah. Leather bad. Sticky.
Sticky. Also like goes under your ass and it's like pleasant.
We think this is a fake leather sofa. There's no way it's real.
The chill person you'll meet. Right.
Yay, nice. The one critique is on what he said was a leather sofa. I am assuming faux. But free sofa. Well, here's the thing. It's slightly different if it's free.
I'll take the I'll take the Chansey.
Why are we keep choosing the same ones to take. I also took the Chansey.
Are you like sitting on your sofas naked? Like, how's it sticky?
In summer, if you wear a skirt and are a female, your leggies will stick. You actually, yeah, no, if you're male, your legs don't stick. But if you're wearing a skirt or shorts or something in summer, you will stick to your sofa. And it's awful.
Yes, I want to keep a record of Tapu Fenius,
please. I think it's pleather. That's fine.
Right, we'll do one spin and then we'll go through. Let's go.
As you say, we've also, you can see it. We've got a, what we assume is fake leather sofa. It came with the flat, but it just, it's bad.
Tapu Fini.
Right, we're going to set up the next
one. Station is Wedgehurst. Oh my god, so that's the first town. So, Pokemon Center is like where the Pokemon Center is. Go down the hill and to the left. There you go.
I like, I don't want to buy a sofa without smacking my bum on it first. Excellent.
Like, many, violently.
Many times I have peeled my leg off the sofa in my old flat. I'm also permanently barefoot and allergic to sitting like an adult. So you get So you get your feet stuck on the sofa.
I do not sit normally. You'll sit cross-legged. I sit cross-legged on no matter what chair I'm sitting on.
I tend to sit with one leggy as if I'm cross-legged on one leggy down. I'm not doing that right now.
That's literally how I'm sitting right now. One leggy down.
Oh my god. I couldn't tell because the bottom half of your leggy is literally underneath your thigh. That's not quite, but close, yeah.
Oh, it's very comfy.
Yeah.
Makes my foot very warm. All right, new lobby is up, everybody. For a Mr. Andy who's in chat, don't forget to go online first.
Or is it like L from Death Note? He does that.
Oh, I do that.
On wooden, like, really? dining chairs.
It's so comfy.
I don't understand. You nearly tip over sometimes. It terrifies me.
Oh, I nearly fall off my chair like once a day.
What do you mean?
I almost fell in the shower
today. You what?
Like. I'm very clumsy.
What do you mean you nearly fell in the shower?
Like, I very much had a moment where I went, huh, everything could have ended.
No, but what happened?
I tripped getting in the shower.
Getting in?
Yeah.
You dumbass.
Kinkira also sits like L all the time.
I'm literally like that right now.
Easy to do with balance. I don't have any, so...
Knees must bend. Easy to do with balance. Yeah, but he's not a short person.
Tall.
Well, I waited to see if anyone wanted to hop in before me, but I'll hop in then.
If we don't get another one in, I'll quit out this one, because we know Alpax is literally running to the DLC, so we can wait a second or two, and I'll just go on a quick walk with my big cube friend for a while. But we'll see if anyone else wants to jump in. About as tall as Luke works for me. Yeah, Dead Dam's about the same size.
Dead Dam is...
Alpax is getting dressed.
Very skinny. Not that you're not skinny, but...
So you may be some time. Get out the clothes store. Down.
No, in real life.
In real life.
Me too, I'm 6 foot.
That's fair.
Nice.
We'll do another one then. Where's... Cobalt, we
know
you're there.
Where you at?
I don't have Sorbet, so hopefully see you well. It's so worth it, especially now with the DLC passes. One second, is he still here?
Not skinny, in shape. I have to ask what the difference is.
There he is.
Thin.
Right. Don't believe we've got anyone else in lobby with the game, so let's... roll. We'll wait till 10.
And to be fair, every shape of body is a shape. Every shape of body is in shape. The shape that it is.
Shapes are fun.
Round is a shape.
Round is a shape. Makes me think of the fat, thin, thin, fat comedy skit.
Sounds better. Skinny is neither a good nor a bad thing. It's just a descriptor. Same
exactly.
As fat.
Yeah.
Fat is not a negative thing, by the way, lads. It's just a descriptor.
Yep. How tall is Luke? Pretty much on the spot, 6 foot.
Yeah, you're about 6 foot.
Aye.
6 foot-ish.
Well, I'm skinny and got small legs, so it's easy.
Aw.
Love it. Right, ready up. And we're going
I am not skinny, and I have kind of long leggies.
Right, Andy, we're going fishing. Oh, also, just because...
But I got thick thighs and a tummy, so they get in the way.
Oh, I don't know. Who do I take here? Geez. Let's go.
I actually have an issue with in shape because I'm going to take the Clefairy that's got life do because it assumes that people that aren't the same body type as you aren't in shape because in shape means like physically fit, you know, etc. And you can't tell fitness or health by someone's shape.
Yeah, no, I agree.
So we'll say thin.
There's no guaranteed great choice. Grass is
there
good.
There you go.
The
Alpax made my joke. I'm in shape. It's a circle. Alpax, you are not a circle.
I don't know what we really want here. We definitely don't want left. We definitely want... Yeah, so we want to go right here. Right here. Right here.
Let's go. My wife says the exact same thing all the time, TSP. Makes me think of this. I don't know what that is. I'm 5'7", I think. Oh, you're about the same height as me. I'm 5'8". Those are not small leggies.
Oh, fuck, you're right. In shape is how you personally feel you are. Like, yeah, not based on other people. Agreed.
But then, everyone's in shape, as I said. And not an accurate descriptor.
Yeah. It's an odd... Like, it's definitely, like... I don't know, I definitely think there's like places for conversation about it, but it's like everyone should be allowed to feel the way they want to feel and the way want to look.
Absolutely.
I mean, I'm going to set up a light screen and chill here. You say I'm skinny, I say I'm in shape. Yeah, simple. Fine, you can make dinner tonight to make it up to me.
Definitely. Well, okay, we'll say definitely not chubby.
Chumby. We love that phrase.
We love the phrase chombi. Like something being chonky or chombi.
Mac and cheese for dinner. I mean, that's what she does, so.
Mac and cheese is good. What?
It's what you order from Frankie and Benny's when we order from Frankie and Benny's.
It's because I want the spaghetti pomodoro, but they don't have it.
Not that we've been ordering from Frankie and Benny's recently, because
we've ordered twice because we wanted cheap takeout
Andy.
On a stressful day.
Andy. You what? Fell over, Andy.
Oh, you're just yelling Andy and not saying anything. Hell yeah, mac and cheese dinner. I love mac and cheese. See, who doesn't like mac and cheese? Other than you.
We're all going over to Glacier Eyes' house for tea. He's cooking for chat.
Mac and cheese is just such a good mood. While we're on it, craft mac and cheese.
Do you use an attack?
Yeah.
What are you using?
Fire. It's all I have.
It's harmless. I guess I just buff up you because I only have a...
cheeky bit of chili. Huh.
You know, put some jalapenos and breadcrumbs on top. If you like your spicy and you like your crunch.
Hockers. I mean, breadcrumbs, yes. I wouldn't do jalapenos because I can't handle spice. But that sounds nice.
Shell some white cheddar.
Oh. Yeah.
I am loving the mac and cheese.
I don't understand. You love pasta and you love cheese. I don't get what you don't like.
It's something else. What's something else there? Something.
You can put things in it. Like they're saying. You can put the ways of bacon in it.
Macaroni in a pot.
That's some wet.
It's a popular food. That's his issue. I'm going to throw this at you. Fidget spinners hurt when they're thrown.
Kraft cheesy pasta is good, bad. 10 out of 10, but fuck. I had pesto cheese. I made mac and cheese from it with some green chilies and spinach. Mwah.
You do so much better than those greens and mac and cheese. Like, mac and cheese is things where I've never had one that doesn't taste artificial.
You cannot make something more tasty.
In theory, I will like it, right? But I've never had one that didn't feel like felt artificial. Fuck a bowl of mac and cheese.
Glacier Eyes, that's the move.
Stop laughing, because I know you would too.
Yeah? Everyone here, other than you and Dead Dan, because you're wrong, would fuck a bowl of mac and cheese.
Literal food porn.
Right? Your family just has
Bonk.
Your family just has a bit of an issue with teaching its young'uns that all junk food, and I'm like in air quotes around this, is somehow bad. I love your family and its food.
Yeah, one second.
But they do that.
One second.
Mac and cheese is my mistress.
Where's the bonk?
Hang on.
Bonk, bonk,
so,
bonk.
Wait. Silent Planet, Glacier Eyes, and mac and cheese are in a threesome.
This is why we have adults only. I'm napping.
Here's some 18 plus advice, lads. Having sex with food involved is called sloshing. I know this from Secret Diary of a Call Girl.
I love you.
Educating all the time, lads.
If all mac and cheese is your only food.
No, they can't do that. Is that advice or just a weird fact?
Is it advice? Yeah, that's a fair point. You did specifically...
I didn't mean to say advice. Education.
I know that because of a documentary on Channel 4 which included painting with your willy.
This is the kind of stuff you come to us for, right, chat?
Like, our door's wide open, by the way. People are going to hear that.
Yeah?
It sounds like you... I just... I don't know what's happening. But wait, Andy, could you stop getting hit, please? And stop just...
Oh my god, the artist is called Picasso. Fantastic. Oh my god, I'm so happy that I know that. Glacier Eyes has lost it. Hey, are you still at work? Are we ruining your entire work day?
I just stopped breathing for like a second.
Take a drink, take a drink. She's taking me to so many Michelin restaurants. I have been to more than my parents combined. That's fine. You can still enjoy non-Michelin style
food. Don't let our family take you off junk food. I didn't get takeout and like proper takeout until I left for university. Like, can you link it to pick they're a bit racy? TSP, send me them first. Because we know each other IRL. You can send me those first and I will tell you whether or not they're Twitch appropriate.
God, that's so funny. We have had titty and ass mouse pads linked, so I guess.
You don't do much, don't worry. Right.
Sloshing is doing the slosh and I refuse to hear otherwise. What's the slosh?
It's a dance.
Is it?
Yeah.
I'm not cool enough to know these things.
It's really lame.
Where do I go from Jake?
Who's Jake?
Who is Jake? Who's not... Oh, it's me. Oh, shit. I didn't mean to use that move. I was literally like, please DM it to me, TSP. And Cheezer, you may not want to be in the chat right now.
Cheezer, we're having one of those conversations where you look at her and go, I'm her mother. I can't be part of this. And gently bail out.
The current conversation is someone who paints with food... In an adult way, and he's called Picasso.
No, he doesn't paint with food, love. He paints with his weenie.
Oh my god. Which is why they're talking about Picasso. But hi, welcome. I'm in the Discord. I need to say Picasso. I need to see. Right, pop it in the Discord. I'm happy with that.
No, she's sending it to me first.
It's just that when you can make better food than the junk food you would get and for less, why have it? It's not always for less, though, Dead Dan. Anyway.
Let's have a quick look. And I am not taking this. I'm keeping the
life, Jew. You all know Joe, though, right? What?
There's a picture of him.
What? That's hilarious. You can send that. You can't see anything.
It's just male-presenting nipples.
Oh, the slosh is for middle-aged Scottish women at weddings. It's not supposed to be cool. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Where are we going?
Let's go... Fuck me senseless, right? And then we want to go grass at the end. This is a bad selection.
Backslot slowly. Couldn't find the Gordon Ramsay one, which is mental. Okay, there's a link, lads.
How approximately you say common junk food cost?
That's, what are we calling junk food? Because, like, right, mac and cheese, you can buy for a quid and make it. Probably much less than that. Yes. If you bought a massive bag of pasta and, like, a huge block of cheese, then one serving of mac and cheese could probably cost you, like... 20p. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. If you figured it out that way. So it really depends what we're calling. If you're calling at home, you can make it yourself junk food, or like go into Mackie's peak level junk food, you know? Either way,
I can't believe we linked that in chat today. I can't believe that we've been streaming for like an hour and this is where we've got to. Y'all need Jesus.
I've clicked on the link and it said forbidden. Alpax, you're not allowed to see the peenie. You're too innocent for that. Oh my eyes. So something that my mum...
God, I'm crying a little bit. I'm hurting.
I'm bringing this back to Picasso with, you know, the naked man.
And you just said the words, something me and my mum, and bringing it back to Picasso.
Just let me talk. Love you. When she was at work, she worked with a couple of different women in quite a small office, and they printed off, I've forgotten what celebrity it was, but like a topless photo of a sexy male celebrity and laminated it and put it on the back door of their office. So when it opened, if there was someone that didn't work there in there, they had to leave the door open so no one would ever see it but them. And their boss found it when they were printing it off and just joined in. How great is that?
So
that's so stupid.
TSP's going to be back 15 to pick up their SO, so they're going to go get Glacier Eyes.
Dead Dab,
never ask the question to TSB, where did you find this thing? Because TSB is a well of... Why are the computer bullying Andy?
Mr. Till doesn't like this goblin man.
That's fair.
Who is the goblin man? I assume Picasso.
Oh yeah, Picasso.
See you soon, Glacierize. I'm not over this.
I, like, genuinely, you have no idea how much, like, weird stuff TSP has shown me in my
King
life.
Kira can't unsee.
That's so funny. You didn't have to click the link. You punished your own eyes.
I mean, I guess.
Also, did Alpax ever respond to when we asked him which Jake he's talking about?
Yeah, who's Jake?
How much alcohol Twilight series amount?
You don't want to know how he sounds. Size of the pictures. Me, I'm the goblin man.
Jake was a young lad. He's dead now.
Oh, he must be one of the kids that you have to battle.
Yeah, he must be one of the kids on the way down to the lake house.
But I love that he just said, who is Jake? Where from Jake? And we were just like...
Don't forget to catch a Yamper on the way by. Why? Because Yamper's cute.
Yamper's so cute. Oh, Octo's gone live. Nice. You guys ever seen pictures of me with friends?
He fixed things!
I emit gremlin energy hardcore. It's alright. Luke got all wrapped up in a quilt the other day and was just peeping at me through it, and that was peak gremlin energy.
I love gremlin energy. Gremlin energy is
amazing. You looked so cute.
You just want to see and couldn't say no at all. Welcome to my life. Like, I'm the same. Oh, if someone says, do not click this link, I'm like,
ding! Done.
Hello? I clicked it 10 minutes ago.
Gremlin friend energy. They're the best friend, right?
Gremlin is such a good mood.
We all like being a bit of a gremlin.
Wet the mouse.
That's some wet ass.
Okay, I'm liking the heal. Doesn't mean we have to go another turn, but...
I feel like a gremlin most of the time.
Ah, do not push red button.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you remember, like, a few years ago when that would you push the button thing went round with different scenarios?
I mean, I believe it still goes around.
Yeah, but you don't seem to see it as much, right? Most of the time, the things that they were asking weren't even, like, that controversial.
No.
Yeah, it'd be like, you can end world hunger, but you will drop a tenner on the floor. Like, oh no.
But my tenner.
Do you know what I mean, though?
But money. But you're... Oh.
My friend and I did a Slav squat on either side of the apartment complex sign. Amazing. When me and my friend went to London a couple of years ago to see a burlesque show, I made them Slav squat all over London for us to take pictures. You know who it is.
Yeah. Is Slav squatting the...
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. I genuinely was sitting there going, what is Slav squatting?
In the middle of the night.
This is decent if anyone wants it, but I am... Probably
I'm alright. Mom doesn't have quite the gremlin energy they used to have. They used to exude at musical theatre.
Yeah, enough. Do you know what? I'm gonna take it.
Your uncle has just messaged us to see what we want for Christmas.
Ah, fuck.
That's so sweet.
Yeah, but I need people in my life to stop asking me what I want for Christmas. It's my least favourite question of all time.
We don't know.
Like,
do you want some more pyjamas?
Not from him. He's the cool uncle.
Exactly. Oh, that's true. Matthew is the cool uncle. What?
I love you. It's like, oh.
JK. What I'm going to do is name every uncle but Jamie.
Who's awesome mouse pad do you want for Christmas? I don't know. I need something sexy on a mouse pad. I want an ass mouse pad so badly.
All your uncles are really the same person.
Yeah.
Having done
just
a couple,
different flavors.
Having done a couple of group calls with all of them in, it's just like, yep, I can tell your brothers. You know?
My friend always tells me I'm the tall version of him. My friends always tell me that they have regrets.
What?
That's a lie, they don't say that. They like me. They like me really.
Yeah. They do.
Andy doesn't. He regrets me.
They like you and they like to bully you. Sometimes.
Oh, yes. Andy regrets.
But that's fine.
Don't you, buddy? Don't you? I pull you on my stream and bully you. I do not think he's listening because I keep yelling at him.
Probably muted.
Who asked, do I want my mouse pad for Christmas?
Well, you did one thingy, right?
A la carte.
Yeah, but very spency.
You're the exact same mindset for a lot of things.
Fair. Me and one of my best friendos are, like, very, very similar. It's quite weird.
Which one?
But then
the,
I suppose
the
that's
one?
Why we're friendos. Yeah. The friend that I mention 90% of the time.
Yeah.
Really, I just have one.
One friend.
Outside of the people that are very regularly in this stream, and they, to be fair, they pop in as well. the one friend that I mentioned. I mention the others occasionally.
We really only count friends that pop into our chat now.
Rio Caspad. Oh my god.
So the one that I want is Alucard. There's an Alucard from the anime, specifically Castlevania anime. Titty mouse pad. Sorry, booby assy mouse pad. God's sake, I'm just gonna say all the words.
Titty
that
booby.
Are, titty booby assy. Ass mouse pad that I really, really want. It's so pretty.
Look how big the Clefairy is, by the way.
It's so fucking
love
funny.
Love it. How bad do you want
to
hug that?
It ships from America, so it's hard for me to get.
Yeah.
I do want it, though. Max Overgrowth. That's not great, but... Andy! Stop! We just lost the raid. Andy died 3 of our 4 times. What happened to you? Oh, he's still alive! Andy, take the Sceptile, for love of God. Please. Please take it. I genuinely thought he'd fainted there. I can be Yuka's death note, right?
Yeah.
Thanks, I didn't know.
You okay?
I haven't seen Death Note in a long time.
One HP, boys. Oh, he does speak.
He does speak. He found us. Hello, I missed you. That's insane, my dude. Like... That was a nightmare raid, and I'm very happy with it. We're not done yet. Andy, take it. Andy. If you press B, I'm walking to your flat and I'm slapping you. Okay? I'm waiting. Betty.
What? Oh, shit.
You
Shit, I don't want it.
If you get it,
Andy better get it.
I'm walking to her flat and slapping. Thank God!
Thank God, I didn't mean to press that. You whisper as loud as you talk.
It's a joke because I whisper loud enough so the microphone picks it up because I'm live on air. I be like that sometimes.
Sometimes one of us will just look at the camera when we can't deal with something that's happening, and I'm looking at the camera now in an appeal to chat to help me. You know?
It's but her appeals are kinda like, you know, like the fucking light like appeals that used to get on TV in charity events. I don't know. Please rescue her. She needs it.
Are you okay?
No. Right, Andy, do a big one. Big up. Big boy. Big boy grassman, go.
I have magical leaf.
Hello, Happy.
Hello. Ah, wait, has it been an hour? Yes.
Happy is like, we've been streaming for about an hour. Signifier.
No. It's Mother. He went to Dunk J.
Yeah, no.
I imagine that takes about an hour.
How is Ramsey and Jacob?
He's going to stare at you. Oh, he did it himself last week.
Yeah.
But still.
Light screen up. I've used a light screen because we want to make sure we have some sort of defense against a potential Surf. Because Surf is our biggest enemy right now. Two of us are hitting naturally, which are me and you, and then the other two resist, but a couple Surfs could actually really, really hard fuck us.
Oh, yeah.
Especially if the fish hits it with a water move. Yeah, I mentioned last week and Ramsey got annoyed me for that. I'm sorry. We're supposed to not, yeah. Oh, nice. You got a super fast move, but we're all good. Nice. We're happy for you. Happy for you.
Yeah, just first name, first letter name, the babby.
Sorry, it was me saying last week. Yeah.
Yeah, I
remember it happening. Me be like, oop.
Yeah, I was like, oh, that should have happened, but it happens. It's fine. It was less him typing it and you saying it. Mentally filter.
I'm bad at that.
Because you're bad. I'm bad. Really, really bad.
Please crit.
Yeah,
Andy, kill it.
Yeah.
I'm so scared of us losing right now because it's down in desperation. So with double surfs, we could die.
It's really weird. It's really weird for me saying J, right? For Le Babi, because I have a cousin called just J. J A Y.
Oh. That's weird.
Yeah. So sometimes I'm a bit like, I have to remember that that's not his full name. I'm going to end up calling him J, I think, for short, just all the time.
I just can't be bothered learning any more than one letter.
Fair enough.
It's difficult for me, you know?
Is that what's going to happen to everyone in chat?
Yeah, B. And I call you B sometimes.
Well, that's from Mum.
No, I started it.
Did you?
Yeah.
Oh, because you type it when you're lazy sometimes.
I type B. So sometimes when I'm messaging, the monster's asleep and hopefully it'll stay that way.
Oh, God.
You said it too soon and you know it. Yeah, sometimes when I'm typing, I will just refer to people by their first letter just because I'm like, I haven't even bothered typing it. If I'm friends with you, I will shorten your name to as few letters as I can physically manage. I'll just be G.
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 Oh, because you're such a G.
You're such a G. What up, G?
Hang on, hasn't TSP picked you up yet? Ramsey's working on her nano. She's hoping to get a target for the day and joining some raids in a little bit. Oh, that'd be great.
No more Al.
Just look. Yeah, that'd be great if...
Right.
Good luck on the writing, because like hitting a target every day would destroy me right now.
I love you. Right, what's yet?
I don't think any of them
are shiny. None of those shiny. I believe all the sprites for this lot are very obvious shinies. The only one I'm not 100% sure on is Skeptile having a good one. Luke, what was your favorite Pokemon game again?
Sorry.
X and Y. Sceptile. I said Skeptile on purpose. It's X and Y. They're my favorite ones by far. I love them so much because they did they did a good mix of a decent-ish world with some interesting stuff, but also I really enjoyed the competitive scene, the way they fiddled up. Hello, Raven, how are you doing?
Hey, Raven.
That's why the single letter names.
I thought you said Ruby Saf. Why don't you hit target you with 40,000 words? Dang, that's a lot of words.
Oh, Connor's back. Nice.
Hi, Connor. Guess I'm Well, you can be no or duh.
Yeah,
we're in the car.
Nice. Oh.
To be fair, I don't even think y'all live in the same country.
Oh, you're tired? I'm sorry. We're also sleepy because I snore through the night and didn't sleep very well, so.
No. Duh would be tuh, to be fair. Because I'm assuming you mean Dora.
I don't know what's happening, but he wants the D. No, that...
Wait, so is happy just huh? Or do you want to be
s? Can we stop this?
But I like doing it as the lowercase letter. Yeah. I think that's much funnier.
Also, kind of good times. We just finished that one, so we're going to jump into another one.
You're just l. And I'm b.
I don't know what's happened. We've lost the power of speech.
Everyone is being only called by their first letter.
Right. Tap Vinny, it's saved. And we go again. Because I haven't had a shiny Pokemon yet on stream. Would not be N and not N.
What?
Would be N, not N. What?
No, we definitely probably maybe aren't in the same country. That's fair. Yeah, I don't know what that damn saying either.
I think it says N, not N.
Yeah, we're saying it as lowercase. So N is capital, N is lowercase. So I'm saying it's funny that it's...
I want to veto... Oh, wait. I just did it without a code. I'm stupid. Got DLC 2 weeks ago. I've been grinding my deck since to get the shiny charm.
Nice.
I did the exact same things. Names are capital letters by default.
Sure, but comedy. This is satire. We are making this choice. Well, it's an attempt. Satire, right? Doesn't have to be funny.
I mean, not all comedy has to be funny, but...
Comedy does, but satire doesn't.
Sure.
Sure, Jan.
Streamers aren't allowed to be funny.
There you go.
Right. Lobby set up, guys. Everyone who wants in, get in. But yeah, when I got the DLC...
Alpax is. Alpax is funny. And he's a streamer.
True. He's the only one.
He's the only one.
Hey, there's Andy. That's why I don't stream. Because she's too funny.
Too funny, yeah.
Yeah, that's fair. But yeah, when I got the DLC, I did like a couple of weeks of raids, and I was like, I don't want to do any more until I've got the shiny charm. And I just grinded out the shiny charm for the rest of the thing. And do you know what? No regrets. One of 100 shiny rates were just, so good.
Oh, yeah.
Like.
Oh, I see a baby.
Okay, you're in. There you are. Yeah, I'm not funny.
I don't know, I think I'm quite funny. There's a bibby.
Where?
She peeping.
One's in snack. What is it on?
I didn't say.
Oh, I thought.
It said singular. Dude, 1 in 100 shiny rate? That's obscene. What's the normal rate?
1 in 4,096. So yeah, I'll take my what I yeah. So in this right, normal rates, no, in like overworld running into Pokemon the Wild, it's 1/4096. If you're using any breeding or other shiny hunting methods, it's 1 in 2,000 approximately. It's halved, I believe. And then if you're doing this mode without the shiny charm, it's 1 in 300. If you're doing the mode with the shiny charm, it's 1 in 100. This mode has been the best odds that have ever been released in Pokemon for getting shinies outside of Pokemon Go.
I'm being slowly there swallowed by the sofa. Comedy has been tested for years. It's funny as a foreign concept to me.
We're going to have a four-man lobby at the very least this one. Because,
yeah, I'm joining.
You joining? Let's go.
I left it a while, but let's go.
Art is dead.
I forgot what I was going to say. My brain isn't working today, Lance. Not that it ever really is.
Tappy Finny, I'm going to grab that Tangela. Terry. These are all bad. Ba 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 dam bum.
Whap.
Finding that is the same as finding a Feebas.
I've got a shiny Feebas in Pokemon Go.
Mm, true.
Hmm. What's best to you?
None of it is good. Because they're all either weak to water or fairy, which is interesting.
I've got, if I take Torkoal, no one's weak to water.
What do you mean?
It's got drought.
It just weakens the power of water, but it's not a bad idea, actually. I'd still go for it. If we're with the double fire team, then the play now is to get this, all our fire Pokemon gone.
Yeah, sorry, I was waving at Worshipper.
I've already waved at Worshipper. Right, water on the right is good for us. Wait, why is it? No, it's not.
I've got drought.
Yeah, true. What is it? Water is probably good. The Ghost of the Dusk thing. Hucknall. But this one gets us grass and an item if we go to the dusk. So yeah, sure. Right's probably best. What water Pokemon is that? I know what it is.
I cannot see it. Is it? It's Cramorant.
It's Cramorant. This is a bad pick.
You want a chance of the Cheeto Bird.
But I want a chance at Cheeto Bird! The same rules are in place. If anyone is raiding with us and anyone gets the Cheeto Bird, I will give them a choice of any of my non-legendary shinies for the... It's not a Cheeto Bird.
Yeah. What? Why did you think it was?
So
cheap. As soon as you said I know what it is, I was like, well, that means it's... Yeah, it's Vaporeon. Sorry, Vapotwan. Come back. No physical leaving. Get up. Why did I say get up? I mean, sit down.
I'm sad. I'm actually just heartbroken right now. I want a shiny Cramorant so bad. Like, of all the Pokemon and all the gym joints in all the world, it's the one I want the most.
So much. Ouch.
Did we just get hazed with no stat changes?
Sure.
Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. We have a Solar Beamer and a Drought. That's great. Kaboom. I thought I G-maxed. I must have missed the button. I meant to G-max for sure.
Is it because you were getting up and leaving?
Yeah. Yeah, it's because I made a physical comedy.
How dare you? You're just not allowed.
Nah, no physical comedy allowed. No comedy allowed, really.
Basically. Well, streamers aren't allowed to be funny.
Yeah,
so.
Streamers aren't funny. Right. Seems I'm not doing it. I'll set up Spongebore.
Spongebore.
Andy, you have fighting moves, don't you?
Yeah.
Why is he hitting you with a fire move then?
Hmm.
TSP dabs back in.
Hey, did you get Glacier Eyes?
Did you get Glacier Eyes?
So introducing them to a significant other. I love this bit. I'm never letting this go.
It's a great bit. I love bits. I absolutely love bits.
Wow, subtle. Do I have any left?
Oh, do you?
Yeah. I do.
I love you. Nah, I picked up some mac and cheese. Yeah, there we go. 2 bits. I love bits. This is a good bit. The bit where we pretend like we're cloying.
There you go.
Oh! Well, thanks, Pettywell, for the 1 bit.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. There's a penny. Oh, here we go. I'm a fiend. I'm a fiend for liking those pennies.
Those tasty, tasty pennies. Hey, at the end of our stream, if Octo's still going, we're going to raid him and give him his change.
Yeah.
So if anyone wants to join in on an Octo stream afterwards, we're going to raid Bisexual Octopus, who is a streaming friendo. we owe him some pennies.
So he came into our stream yesterday and asked us for our favourite numbers, which are 13 and 499 respectively, and then gave us bets equal to the favourite numbers. So Betty got 13, I got 499, but he accidentally donated...
Well, he said, give me the penny change as a joke, but he accidentally did 600 instead of 500.
So we're going to raid him later on, and I'm going to give him 101 bits and just say, your change, sir. Because that's just funny.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's just
we will make fun. We will make not Dalmatians jokes.
It's your change, not Dalmatians. I like it. One for each Dalmatian to make Mimi jealous.
There you go. The digital sequel to 101 Dalmatians. Me and TSP went to the same place.
I love it. It's probably worth one of our fire Pokemon taking this, just so we're not like triple on fire when we go into the water legendary at the end.
Sure. Who, though?
I don't know. I'd probably say Andy. He's the weakest.
I'm happy taking it. It's just I have drought.
Like, the fact that you and Kanna have a drought solar beam set up, which is good. So for people who don't know, the move solar beam usually takes two moves if it's in heavy sunlight, which is set up by drought.
And Andy loves Vaporeon anyway.
Hey chat, are we all in the Northern Hemisphere here? Which part is Texas in? I believe it's Northern. It's Northern.
Yeah, that's North.
What part is it in? America? And we go Ghost Frightem again, I say. Ghost Frightem? Yeah. Like, take the item choice, because the Noctowl doesn't do much for us.
From South America? Cool. We've
got some smack to talk in Aussies.
Yeah, why? Why are you asking, Mr. Tiller?
I feel like it's going to come, but...
Got some smack to talk against Aussies. Is it hilarious?
I love
See, Alpax exists. The one funny streamer.
Which fear me? You're north. Animal Crossing?
Oh, I've got nothing good.
Oh, Animal Crossing is probably the right answer. I'm taking the Citrus Berry, because it's the best I can do.
Oh, Animal Crossing. Which part of Texas? It'll be in Northern Hemisphere, yeah. Because I want to talk about...
Winter beverages, but it's only relevant.
Oh, sure. Right. Winter beverages. What do we like, lads? No, I mean, I'm from Texas.
Oh, right.
Oh.
Nice.
Wait. I was being so confused. We might have two Texas people.
Love good hot toddy. Well, there you go. That.
Oh, hot chocolate. That's a power move. Happy.
Malt wine. I like a hot chocolate. Like, I hot really chocolate. Do.
Horlicks. If anyone knows what
not,
that is.
I have not tried Horlicks.
I need to get us some. There's two things on the shopping list. Shit, what was the other thing I said? Cherry juice. Because it's cherry god.
Oh my god.
I'm going to what?
Oh, I need to look at tea. Because I started drinking tea again. I'm actually enjoying winter months because I'm getting back into hot drinks. I just love a hot drink.
I'm not Dynamaxing, by the way. What?
Yeah, the water is a bit hurt because, we've got drought set up, but I'm going with the Sun Sword set up and just trying to see if we can get something done. Weather Ball's a good choice, Andy.
Mulled wine is S tier, hot black currant juice if I'm feeling childish. I've never had hot black currant juice.
Fair.
And I really want to now.
It's officially cold weather, took a massive thermos of green tea to work.
Chai! That's what I have to say.
She likes her chai. Chai. Actually. Right. Spin the wheel. Let's go. Power whip. Vodka is a good winter drink. Gotta get through the pain of those cold, dark nights.
Mm-hmm.
I am.
A fifth Sagittarius star? Damn it.
I thought vodka was traditional in Citrus Flask.
You only get the best water here, though. So, not true.
So, Jay, the 1-year-old, likes his mint tea.
Huh. That's incorrect. So, an alleged, but also, water in Glasgow, if you live in an apartment complex, because Scottish water is supposed to be the best water in the world, right? Tastes awful. I'm sorry.
You're
but
incorrect.
In
Scottish water is
in
delicious.
This flat,
it's so good.
In this flat, and my friend's flat that I lived with for a bit, the water was fucking awful.
Our mum, like me and Happy's mum, can't have her mint tea and Jay's Vincent tea without Jay going
I'm
for
hearing
it.
B, what? It could just be because we live in a flat, and like, when you live in a flat, water's usually worse than if you live in a house. And where I'm from is the hardest water in the UK. And
you
I like that.
Yeah, you can punch that water and it leaves an indent.
You get hard and soft water dependent on the different minerals, etc. that are in it. and I like hard water.
A fifth Sagittarius star. TSP's up to seventh.
A seventh?
I'm living for...
just B. What? Mom can't have a mint tea and Jay's vicinity without Jay going for it. That's hilarious.
Yeah.
Can't even believe I have to hear this anti-Scott water blasphemy. As I've said, it might be fine elsewhere, but this flat, it's awful.
Yeah.
And it could just be because this flat is a mistake.
I think it's fine here. Since Texas is in a perpetual drought, the water here always tastes like someone pissed in your water filter. Nice. As long as they filter out all the yellow stuff, it'll be fine.
Hey, maybe I should just get a Brita filter again.
We probably want to go grass here. It's an Eldegoss. Shiny Eldegoss chance.
Ooh.
What's the fighting Pokemon there? It's Passimian.
I bought a water filter for myself when I lived at uni because, again, the water in student flats just tasted awful. And my ex fucking stole it.
So Alpax has just hit the DLC and said, flip it out, the elephant's level 70.
Oh dear.
I guess you don't need to win then.
I don't think you do. Did you hear what I said?
Yeah, you're filtering your old flat and your flatmate stole it.
My ex stole it. How fucking rude is that?
It's pretty nice.
And my Hoover. I had a little orange stick Hoover. It was really good. It would have been perfect for living here. But whatever.
Yeah, it would have been. So it's up to you and Kana to beat this.
That's fine.
Well, Alpax, just accept your loss to the elephant. Bow down to his greatness and see what happens when the elephant crushes you.
Also, best water for me is my home water because we are right by spring, so it's super nice.
Fair.
I
don't taste the difference in waters unless I'm in England where it's bad.
But it's different in all areas of England because if you go super down south, like some of my family's from Essex, their water's really soft and it just tastes fucking gross. So, I don't know.
Ah, so for the first fight against Peony, you can win or lose it. It doesn't matter. There we go.
Cool.
We are. Should I take this?
Who keeps paralyzing it when I keep trying to burn it?
Me? Bitch. I didn't know you were trying to burn it. I've been saying I've been using Stun Spore, but that was an accident. I hit it with Body Slam.
Right. Should I take this? I have Sunny Day anyway.
I'd say either it's you or Betty takes it. One of the fire types should take it.
My tiny American brain always forgets that Hoover is a vacuum. Sorry. That's so funny.
Hoover's a great name. I don't know.
Well, it literally goes, Hoover's it up.
I love you so much.
Are you telling me that's not the noise that Hoover makes?
You are correct. It does.
Bitch.
What it actually goes, dunk, dunk, and gives me a heart attack because I hear dunking, and I'm like, what's happening? It's like, oh, it's a Hoover in the hallway. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, that's... So there are cleaners for, like, the communal areas of our building, and they just bash our door with the Hoover all the time.
I would say it's probably better for Betty to take it because she has one non-fire attacking move and it's rapid spin. So I'd say you grab this.
Sure.
And you like Eldegoss. Okay. It's got light screen. Light screen's good.
Ba, ba, ba.
Ba, ba, ba. Oh, you're right. I'm just deep-brain.
No, you're not all. Like, when you live in different areas and you just have different names for things, you just kind of forget what the other colloquial names for things are.
Yeah. Once served a German at the cafe who asked for water. As I always did, I asked tap water since that's free and bald. And she responded, no, in a very incensed and bewildered way. I was very insulted. Just like,
I still am, clearly. The thing is, in some countries, they just don't drink tap water. They just won't drink tap water like in restaurants and stuff.
And also some
and
people
I'm
are
like,
just
why? Wise. It's free. It's fucking water. What do you think's wrong with the tap?
And some people are just asshole to staff.
I guess we just have much better water filtration in the UK than some countries do.
Maybe.
Through the taps. I genuinely think that that is a thing.
Tap water in a lot of countries is not safe to drink.
There you go.
Fair. Yeah. You know what the goddamn weirdest mental disconnect is? Speaking to an American friend one day and realizing that Burke and Hare are peculiarly Scottish piece of history. Yeah. They would be.
What?
Burke and Hare. They were Edinburghian grave robbers.
Why would I offer it?
Lanzarote,
you can't drink tap water. There's no natural water spring. See, this is what I'm saying. There's a lot of countries where they don't drink tap water.
Yeah.
We're really fortunate for that.
Broken Hair, were they serial killers or grave robbers? They were grave robbers, right?
I don't know who they are.
They were based in Edinburgh. in essence, I can't remember if they grave robbed or murderers. Yeah, they were just grave robbers. But they, in essence...
Oh, the triple grave robbers, though.
Yeah. My brain was just very much on a... Did they...
Cubed? Oh, the maths teacher coming in with a maths joke.
In essence, they robbed graves and then sold the bodies on for medical science.
Oh.
So they very much were like passing the bodies on to universities to make money.
Oh, them.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Broken hair. Weirdly enough, where I'm from, there's a golf course where there's a little hut in the middle of it where it's rumoured that Burke and Hare stayed one time when they were running away.
Oh. I think some sensationalised stories imply they did a murder or two. Huh.
Part of the movie was filmed at Stirling Castle. Oh god, there was a movie! I think me and Alpac saw that in the cinema like a long time ago. Huh.
I am at Lady. Cool.
Oh, you can get the next one. Nice.
Then we'll get you in the next
one.
We
did not. Was it me and Happy? It wasn't bad. It must be me and Happy then. I could have sworn it was me.
Oh, you and Happy went to cinema together.
At least once, as siblings do.
Yeah, but, you know.
We saw Step Brothers and walked out. We didn't walk out of Step Brothers. We watched the entire thing of Step Brothers. I remember the ending of Step Brothers. I've never wanted to see it again.
At least twice. You and Happy.
At least twice. Apart, I like the fact that we're just arguing about now. Me and my immediate friends and family just talking about what movies we've seen. There was a photo of me holding a snowy owl at Harry Potter. That's true.
Oh, that's really cool.
Yeah, I was too young to do it. I was allowed to hold the birds.
We still have a very long-standing, over a year-long promise now.
Yeah.
With one of our friends to go to the Scottish, was it Owl and Eagle place or whatever it is.
Yeah, there's like an owl rescue place. Outside of Edinburgh, we keep wanting to go. This raid has been really easy for us. I feel like the drought has absolutely crippled the Tapu Koko.
Have you ever touched an owl?
No.
I have. I've held an owl.
I've not held an owl.
It's really cool. If we go do an experience, I will warn you. And if we go with other said friend, I'd also quite like to take my dad one day. There will be like. Bits of meat and whatever that they feed them,
yeah,
to like do tricks and training or whatever with them, but it's fine, it's not too bad.
TSP's held an eagle, owl and boy chunky, and Happy has been to the place with our cousins.
Aren't they chunky?
Then there's Chunky.
He's dead. Chunk. So they wouldn't let us chunky. Hold the fuck me, I'm doing a brain fart. Americans, what's your bird?
Eagle?
What eagle though?
Bald. Golden.
Is it the golden eagle that I'm thinking of, I think? They wouldn't let us hold that for more than about 5 seconds because it was so heavy. Bald eagle. Okay. Which, it was fucking massive, whichever type of eagle it was.
There's I think it's sea eagles, what they're called, in Edinburgh Zoo. That is huge. I love him. He's ginormous.
You still owe me a date to Edinburgh
Zoo?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know what? We can go when the world opens up again.
It's been a year and a half.
Bald eagle.
You made me that promise.
Is that the same place as the kites? I don't think so.
You haven't been there. Oh, that's really cool.
I don't know. There's a specific place outside Edinburgh which is cool. Right.
Bald eagle.
Fingers crossed. Let's go. Give me your luck. That's not shiny.
If you ever go to Prague, make time to see the zoo. Prague is so much less likely than, you know, Edinburgh. No shinies.
Andy? Any luck?
I took the Elder Goss, obviously. And Connor.
I'm taking the V-Prime.
Oh, yeah. If you ever go to Prague, it's amazing and huge. Me and Ramsey were there all day and didn't see everything. Cool. My primary school would have like a bird sanctuary group come to give assemblies. We did that. And they would yeet dead mice into the assembly. Oh.
He got one.
That's awful.
1 second.
Shiny Vaporeon.
Andy got a Shiny Vaporeon. There it is. Pink. I'm so proud of you, my son.
Don't come to America. Our zoos are only mediocre and people here kind of suck sometimes. The thing is, mostly in the UK, our zoos are like conservation zoos now. They're not like entertainment zoos as much as they are running conservation and need money. So popularizing and touristying it. Makes the money to keep it running.
Right. Alpax wants primary school.
Like the deep.
Cool. I'm so proud. Like, what we all don't know, by the way, for people don't know, Andy, one of Andy's favourite Pokemon is Vaporeon. He's got a shiny one, so I'm so proud of you, son.
Alpax, right. Can you give him primary school instructions to connect?
Right, Alpax, press Y on your controller. Loads up this screen. Press plus, connect, and it will say connect to internet.
You want to do that?
That lets you go on the internet. Then what you do is you talk to this nice lady here, and she's like, oh, hello, would you like to embark on a Dynamax adventure? Then you say, yes, please, lady. And then when it comes to this screen, you just say, anything's fine, because we're picking the raid. We're in charge. You save your game, and it goes, saved. Then on this screen, you press plus, and you type in our magic number, which is 83353.
Slow down a little bit.
000.
Just slow down for him a little bit, and just give him a chance to catch up. Give him a minute.
Okay, and then you press okay. And then once you press okay there, it should be in the top right, and you press invite others.
Zuzi only goes to the ape exhibits. We did spend 10 minutes cackling as we watched a llama chase a goat around the pen trying to bite it in the tick. Oh my god.
One of my favourite zoo stories is me and my friends were at a zoo. Andy was there, so Cobalt Human Chat is there. With a couple of friends. Go without me. Why? What's wrong? Oh yeah, you pressed the wrong button?
It's alright, go back. Just go back.
What button have you pressed?
We've got 2 whole minutes. Also, lads, it is up if anyone wants to join.
What have you done? Have you started one? I feel like he's actually started one. We're so excited. Right, I'm going to finish. You press go without people. You just started one.
That's fine. We'll get you on the next one.
We'll get you on the next one then. Get you a chance to practice and figure out what all the Pokemon attacks do. Everyone else, jump in.
Do we want to do this again, or does anyone want to do a different one?
You don't want to do this. You want to do Blacephalon?
I don't mind. No, I do not want to do Blacephalon.
You don't want to do Blacephalon?
I will if someone else wants to. Right. You don't count.
But yeah, so the story in question, so I was halfway through telling something and then we got distracted. I'll just sit in this menu while we wait for everyone in. We were at Edinburgh Zoo, and we were at the monkeys. And it was a busy day. Like, it was a summer day, and there was, like, a bunch of, like, schools and such going through. And there was a group of kids. And I just remember vividly looking around, and the phrase, Mum, was it not the baboons? I think maybe baboons or some kind of ape simian. And the expression was, Mum, where did that monkey get a creel? And like the speed at which all the parents in the area turned and took their children out as a monkey started to play with its crayon. No, Cobalt's about to like completely explain the exact quote.
Oh, I've never been to Whipsnade Zoo.
It's Gemma. No, Gemma just requoted it. It was a kid who said it first. Gemma being a friend of ours.
I've been to a safari park.
Right.
The Yorkshire Safari Park is also really nice. You just walk around that one though. But it's beautiful.
You guys ready to get the red pen? She said that afterwards. Like, it was genuinely, I assure you, a kid said, where'd the monkey get the pen or crayon first? We had to explain that it wasn't a pen.
Oh, dear.
I swear there was a whole thing with kids doing it. Was it Gemma? Am I going mad?
Also, Andy, don't forget to press OK.
Is that Longleat or is that somewhere else? Gemma was convinced. She cackled and cried.
I might have been to... Oh no, I don't think I've been to Longleat too.
Come on, cool squad, we're going. And we'll do it fast so we can get Alpaca on the next one. When World War II happened, they evacuated the animals in London Zoo. Said they were much happier there because there was more space.
I really want to go do something with animals soon. Love, pick you all.
Oh. I'll take the Cradley, but it's not great. Most of this is just neutral, so it doesn't really matter. Your brother got out the car in the lions at Longleat. Your father was not happy. That's amazing in a way. Terrifying and awful, but also great.
That's crazy.
No drive through sex, there's a little steam train that goes through the safari.
That's sweet.
Choo-choo. Right. We either want electric grass or poison. There's electric and a grass at the end. Give me a second. We want to go down right path? In a way, it doesn't really matter, but we just want to do the ground and we want to wind up here. So, yeah, right path.
Ba-ba-da-ba.
And Wallabies just run wild. Well, you got to dip out for now, guys. Enjoy the rest of the stream. Thanks so much for joining us. Enjoy the rest of your day.
He's got home now. He's with TSP.
Fuck my
See you later. Have a good day.
Connection just shat it. I'm sorry. I was wondering where... No, you were... it go? What happened? Hello, Gradley.
I love the phrase chat. I just love think it's great.
Specifically, you TSP, your wife, but love you too.
Hope to see you soon.
I've got Sludge Bomb. Why?
This is making me want to see animals so badly. Like...
I'm sorry. I've just realised when you use the words, the flavour text for the attack Sludge Bomb does specifically say unsanitary sludge, unlike that regular sanitised sludge.
The stream
just stopped.
Oh, weird.
You can do that.
You can pause it.
It is, yeah.
Which is a really weird thing.
Like, yeah, you can. Look at my giant plant. Like,
awful.
Cradley is probably one of the worst fossils. Like, that generation of fossils, so this is the same game as Cradley and Anorith and the Armaldo, are probably my least favourite, fossils of all time. Like, I love fossil Pokemon. They're my favourite, like, subset, right?
Mm.
And these ones are just probably the worst. So, your rant why which still is best to, along with a lot of conservation work. Conservation work is important.
Fair.
So, if you're ever south
to
go
I'd love to.
Like, I'm going to be honest, there's probably not a zoo in this world I wouldn't go to.
Unless it was awful and not about conservation.
Oh, yeah. I dropped the fidgets for now.
I mean, you did well not to drop it for that long.
Where are you dropping this from?
Those of you who play D&D with Luke sometimes, does it give you flashbacks of him dropping dice on the floor?
Oh yeah, did you hear they found the first ever complete T-Rex skeleton recently?
And yes, I did!
In a battle with
Triceratops.
Oh yeah, I read about this, but I didn't read much about it, but like it's so cool. Not the random big cat rescue place that's in my village. And we found about it because there's a four in a bed.
So Four in a Bed is a UK show about people that run bed and breakfasts, and they go and rate each other's like hotels and bed and breakfasts and stuff.
So it's Come Dine With Me but bed and breakfasts,
basically.
Cool.
I can feel myself spinning in my chair right now. What?
Ma'am, I feel like it's about the dice dropping.
Oh, I was having exactly that explanation.
I am a clumsy little boy, right? And I like to fiddle with things because of ADHD and terrible things going wrong on my brain. But I'm clumsy,
ADHD
so they
is
go.
Not terrible. Wee! ADHD is just a thing.
Yeah, but I'm really bad for it when I play Dungeons and Dragons because I drop dice. I drop dice like an idiot. Oh no, Cradley.
Well, that did nothing.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. But also, I don't care about Cradley, so I don't love him. I wonder what Shiny Comfey looks like.
Comfey is so cute.
Comfey is cute. I like it a lot. Oh, yeah, but it being in my village my whole life, and everyone else knows who lives in the area, but I have no clue about this big cat sanctuary.
Is it Comfey or Comfey?
I would say Comfey.
He's saying a mixture of the two, so that doesn't help me.
I'm saying my way, Comfey.
But what letter are you saying? U or O?
Oh, it's
Comfey. Are you saying it as if it's a comb?
Kinda.
Like you're brushing your hair with it.
Yeah.
But he's comfy.
I don't know.
Like he's like comfortable.
Pronouncing Pokemon names is a bad argument to get into all the time.
I'm not
like...
arguing, I'm asking.
No, I just...
But yeah, being
I've always
been like
comfy.
Everyone else I know lives in the area also had no idea about the Big Cat Sanctuary. They were just like panthers within 2 miles of home. That's incredible.
That's hilarious.
I wish I had that.
There are no panthers where I come from. And there are no panthers in Glasgow, as far as I'm aware.
Someone bought a load of land behind a house to start a small like rescue centre for exotic... I should have taken that. For exotic animals that weren't supposed to be in the country.
That's cool.
And,
yeah, you
and people like would take them in as pets and stuff and then try and get rid of them. And they would just be like, right, we'll build an enclosure for it and try and, you know, like look after it. They amassed a bunch of weird stuff. It was cool.
The bug is electric, so it's super effective against the final boss. We could have also gone item theoretically, but this is just like more damage.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not too difficult for us to fight. Well, it shouldn't be. Could be a bit of a pain depending on what we have.
Oh, him, yeah.
It's Vikavolt, yeah. Only problem is it means that one of our shiny chances is on Vikavolt, and Vikavolt smells bad. Oh, Alpax, if you're done, you need to get Pokeballs as well. Don't forget to buy some Pokeballs.
The end ones, they're all guaranteed catches, so just use the very basic Pokeballs.
You need 4 per run. Whiz.
He do like your fidget spinnies.
They meet me here.
He, for ages, I kept saying, oh, why don't you get Leon a fidget spinner? Leon gave him 25. I kept saying, why don't you get a fidget spinner? And he was like, no.
Well, I didn't because they're less tactile to be like a fidget cube. You only use 6 on Slowpoke.
I love it.
I love it. I have 500 and I don't feel like I've got enough right now.
What do you mean you don't feel like you've got enough? I've only got about 30 at the minute.
You have no other money? Maybe there's another way we work it out. What? We're talking about balls here.
He literally did that to me the other night because I was like, oh, I need to move a shelf down on the bookshelves to get a bigger thing in. And one of the little supports just would not move. And I was like, do we have pliers anywhere? And he was like, oh my god, we actually do. And then he pliered the little thingy out and moved it for me, and he turned around like, oh, am I a big hunky man doing man things?
I felt like a handyman.
And he said, you need to pay me for my services, and we did the whole bit because we're so funny.
We're very funny.
Nah. But it was just how much he turned around like, you're so pleased with yourself.
I was so pleased with myself. Like, I do not do most things that include hard work or effort.
There were four bits needed down and the shelf. He pliered out one of the bits because I'd already done the other three. But
mine,
you know,
was the stuck one.
True. But I could have done it if you just handed me the pliers.
Which
is what
they're
I wanted.
My pliers.
I need to bring my tools up.
I'm right here.
I have so much stuff that I just wish was here.
But soon we'll actually have some of that stuff up here.
Yeah, that'll be great, won't it?
Soon
our game collection is going to double in size.
Yeah, we're soon going to have a PS2 in this flat, and we'll be able to potentially stream some PS2 games, which is exciting.
Really, really exciting. No promises, because apparently it's a pain in the ass, but we'll try.
I don't think it's going to be a pain in the ass. The only thing we need to do is get a HDMI to thingy
Scott.
Splitter. Yeah.
Maybe.
Klonoa 2, I can find, we can do Enter
it's
the Dragonfly.
On, but Klonoa 2 is on the PS3 store anyway.
We need an HDMI SCART adapter. That's the only thing we should need, and then we should be good to go. And like, I've had a look and they're not expensive on Amazon, so.
Oh, giving old Jeff some money.
Oh, is it? Wait, oh, is what?
What?
I got said, oh, is it? On that note,
yeah, it's on the PS3 store.
You turned up your, oh, is it? Oh, I didn't know that. It's not PS4 store. No, it'll be PS3 store only. You have found your copies of Ratchet and Clank recently.
Awesome.
You say copies plural. Is that like just your copy of Ratchet and Clank, or is it a copy of the Ratchet and Clank like trilogy?
Yeah, so it'll be multiple games, right? I assume not PS4 store. No, just on the PS3. My brother's desperate to show it to his boyfriend. Aww. I don't think it's on the PS4 store because when we did it. We did it on PS3 because we got it on the PS store on there. I think all three. I mean, homage. I also have the Jak and Daxter games on PS2. Or just Jak, I suppose. It's not Daxter yet.
These games are mine.
Oh, are they?
Unless he rebought them. Those are mine. Ratchet and Clank 1 was definitely mine because I remember exactly how I learned about Ratchet and Clank. I asked for it for my birthday or Christmas. It was definitely one of my presents. I'm having this fight with my brother on air.
I'm staying out of it. See, I just don't know how you would ever. I just don't know how you wouldn't know whose things were whose.
If no one else wants this, I'll take this and you can get the next grass.
Well, what do you think?
There's a grass thing coming up after.
If you want it, have it. I don't really care.
Yeah. Didn't think you would. I've just absorbed all your brother. That's you with all the games you have. You absorbed your brother's games, just laid claim to them.
Fair. Ratchets 1, 2, and 3.
Great. If they're the ones we grew up with, some of those belong to me!
We're going grass, right?
Oh, yeah, we're going grass. No doubt about it.
Because I grew up an only child, lads. So I just want to clarify. I have a half-sister.
Here we bought them.
I have a half-sister who's 18 years older than me. We've never lived together. I've grown up as an only child.
That's fair. I need to rebuy a bunch of my old PS2 games. I don't know where any of them really are. I need to also raid my attic at some point and find some of those. See what's in there.
Yeah.
It's pretty shite.
Yeah.
Citrus berries are alright, but
I just didn't really know when I was running out of time, so I just took a quick claw. Yeah. Well, maybe over Christmas we could raid your attic.
It's cold up there, but we will go up there.
That's fine. We can find all the photos. Hey, happy Tempesta. Did any photos of you and Luke get put in a certain WhatsApp group chat recently? Just asking for a friend.
I haven't seen the WhatsApp.
I'm asking
my
for
family me. WhatsApp group ping up.
Because if they haven't, please remind your mum and dad that they were going to do that.
Please don't. I hate right. pictures of me as a kid.
If you don't, me or Pip will.
There's old photos of mum for her family. Yeah, there's some old family photos.
Huh. They said they'd found photos with you two in it.
Hey, Andy, who healed there?
Not me.
Andy healed, I think.
What's up with that?
Just, there's no need to heal. There is now.
I don't have a heal, so... I took the wrong person.
Well, you could have saved that Maractus. This is all your fault, Jafar. Spent to heal Maractus. It probably wouldn't have helped anyway. If you get the Dynamax pockets for you, this one.
Okay.
Because...
Yeah.
Chunk. But I don't know where it is on the...
Or, got it.
Yeah, it was on me, first round. I didn't think it was, but sure. Bug buzz. I don't know how I feel about Vikavolt. Like, a lot of the...
He's a bit weird.
...early game bug Pokemon, I don't know exactly how to feel. Ramsey, hello!
Ramsey! Hi! How you doing?
Is that you finished your NaNoWriMo for the day?
Grats on over 40,000 words.
I don't think I know 40,000 words.
For a writer?
Not a very good one, because...
Yeah, I'll shut off.
Yeah. And he's confused after you. Nice. Did you get to go next?
I hear the monster's actually asleep today, which is nice. Ooh, that was a nice bit of damage.
Just be quiet.
Yeah, no yelling.
There's the whispering stream now, guys. We're not allowed to do this. We get told off for any ASMR, ASMR adjacent things we do. Oh, I don't want to be poisoned. F off, Gloom. Right, dead. Psst, after this raid, I may need to take a moment to where you get to sit in solo stream.
You okay? Do you need to pee? That's fine. We can set up the next one.
Nice. I'm just so hype I caught the shiny today.
Based on whoever wants to play, I'll probably be sitting the next one out anyway, so I can just set up another one.
You can just do one if you want on this profile.
Yeah, so I was going
to... Sure.
The only problem is we won't have you to tell us which path to take.
Oh, you can figure it out.
No. Do I want this?
Yeah, you want this.
Oh.
I believe you get priority over Pionia.
Yeah, I think you get priority over NPC.
Yeah. There you go. Don't be so gloomy. Every time I finish a thread, you stab your needle back into the same place, and every time you need to pick it back up again, I spend 5 seconds wondering where I put it.
Excellent.
Me, every time I put down anything, it's like, where? Help.
That's an ADHD mood. Puts it down, forgets it exists. It's like, for us, if we put something in a drawer so it's not immediately viewable, we sort of forget we own it.
Yeah.
It's a really weird thing where we have to have everything on display or we will just forget we own it.
Yeah, that's true. I do not believe I own underwear until every morning when I open the drawer. Oh, come on, it's a little funny. Joke. Love you.
Love you too. Menace.
Yep, that's me.
It is a thing, though. No.
Give me shiny Tapu Fini. Give me shiny Fish Lady. Give me... Suicune is meant to be yellow, right? No, Suicune is blue, love.
Oh.
Give me a second.
Has he got a shiny?
I don't think you do. Give me a second. Suicune is blue.
Yeah, it's blue.
Raikou is the yellow one, and Entei is the red one.
Entei.
Shiny Suicune has dark blue hair when it should be purple, and then it's got lighter blue and white chest.
I really want to know how to actually say that.
What, Suicune? Yeah. Prince Suicune.
I just don't know if it is.
It's one of the few ones I went to the anime to figure out how it's said.
Oh. The English anime, though?
Yeah. Mm. All Pokemon have Japanese names.
Ma'am, have you looked into needle minders? Makes the whole thing way easier. Ooh. So, I've been saying for a few weeks on stream, oh, I really want a new creative project. I think that thing might be embroidery.
Yeah, Little Mage is not a thing I've heard of.
Ooh. Ooh.
Also, we're going big, boys. It's time for the big bugs. If I get two shinies in one day, I'd be so happy. Like, I still can't believe I got the stack attacker this morning. Just like randomly being like, a raid, and then it's just like, oh, big boy. Ooh, Ramsey, drop the link to that Pokemon Cross Stitch in here.
Ooh.
We like Pokemon. We like Cross Stitch. What do you think of Tapu Fini?
I like Tapu Fini.
I really like the Tapus. I think.
However, when you use Tapu Fini, it's shit from the back.
Yeah, because it's just like a little shell.
Yeah. I believe I said earlier it's Hyper Femme Cloyster.
Yeah, you did. And we said we're going to say that. I made a really big point. We're saying that stream. It's really funny.
Because I actually really want to get into something like that. My grandma can't do a lot of her sewing stuff anymore because she actually taught me to sew when I was a kid. And as such, I think is wanting to get rid of like a lot of her supplies for that stuff. And I might be like, does anyone want it? If they don't, can I have some?
We have an explanation as to what a needle minder is. It is basically an animal pin with a magnet on the back instead of a pin. So you put it on your fabric, and then you just put your needle on. Oh my god! The magnet keeps on. That's amazing.
I do have a tomato thing filled with beans. It's also covered in every pin I own. I used to have one of the tomatoes as well, with a little chili hanging off of it.
I have never been this sort of crafty. I'm not good with my hands. Like, I can do creation in terms of like writing or music or something like that. What are you thinking, love?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
See, I know exactly what you're laughing at here, and I'm just gonna sit here for a second. Oh, Maractus is Storm Drain!
Way!
No. I learned basic sewing skills because I had to keep fixing up my massive gorilla toy after my brother wrecked it. Stream's cancelled, guys! We did it! We just did a bad thing! Thought crimes.
I didn't even say anything!
Thought crimes have occurred.
I had to restart his leg back on every 6 months. Oh, that's really sad.
We're all thinking it.
We were all thinking it. See, it's Worshipper. He's the bad man.
I dropped my fidgets.
That actually sounds really cool, though. The fuck, I've already forgotten what it's called. I'm scrolling back up. The needle minder.
Yeah, I like that.
Hey, mate, have to get one. Yeah, I really want something.
Because oh my god,
even if I just go online,
you.
Sorry, even if I go online and like look up ideas or buy patterns and stuff, because sometimes I don't want to have to come up with what I'm doing. I just want something to kind of do while we're doing something else.
Yeah, you don't want to be like the big creative. You just want to like have it get off by your hands.
Sometimes I want to be the big creative. Sometimes yeah. I don't want the pressure of that, and I just want to make something because I like physically creating.
You can learn how to actually do clothes. I actually feel like I really need to state one thing. If we are doing it, you are getting something to help hold needles, because you have a bad habit of, when you sit here, putting stuff on the couch. If you put a needle on the couch and I sit on it...
I won't do that with a needle, will I? I'll stick it in the sofa. In all seriousness, in my old house, I had a divan base on my bed, and there was a bottom corner that had a lot of pins sticking out of it at one point when I was heavy into sewing and stuff as a kid. You couldn't do anything. They were like, you had the little pins with the bobbles on the end. But I did stick them in the end Chinese of my here. Divan base. I don't know why I did that. I'm taking the Vicar Vault because I don't have one. Here are the Pokemon cross-stitch patterns. Happy mention. I'm working on Gen 1. I'm just going to copy message.
TSP, fuck you. My bum is perfectly nice, thank you.
Excuse me? Lucas doesn't have enough bum to realise he's sat on it? And my comment comes from personal experience?
What personal experience you have with my bum?
I love Oh Jesus Wept. I'm just going to click on that link for a sec.
It's on my phone.
Why can I not click on it? There we go.
Oh, it's these. I've seen these before, they're really cute.
Oh, these, I love them. They are really chaotic. Like, just in terms of, I think that might be too much for me for now.
There's no Sword and Shield but...
No, my own bomb, not yours. Oh,
I was so concerned.
I'm not making any comments on either of the bombs involved.
Did you make a comment on my bomb?
You both have lovely bombs.
Thank you. Mine's better, though. I'm just gonna take a moment. Bye. If you want to do a different one, there's your chance, love.
Right, lads. Does everyone still want to do Tapu Fini? You only have Landorus or Xerneas. Do you want to do a Xerneas one? He's a deer.
You also got yours.
But I want to do that.
You want to do Xerneas? Go for
Xerneas. I can't do mine, can I? If I'm not in the raid.
Oh, yeah, of course. I forgot. Yeah, let's do Xerneas.
But I want that. So, no, we're doing another Tapu Fini. Actually, let's do a random one. By the way, to those of you who haven't played very much, if you take the legendary and it's not shiny, it's the only one you can take. You will not be able to take another one.
Yeah, if you do random, go for it.
Right. Let me set it up first, because otherwise y'all will start a lobby without me. If you want the... If you keep forgetting the code, you can type !raid to get the code. Right, it's up. The Panda Center have loads of free Pokemon ones, including individual Pokemon and stuff, if you want something less mad. Yeah, you'd maybe want to start with something like slightly smaller, but Pokemon ones is actually a decent shout. I just really want it. Wow, Alpacs. What is that picture? I assume that's your character? What the heck? He is manic. But yeah, I'd probably want to start with a bit smaller. I'm just like craving something to keep my hands busy, I suppose, in a creative sense. And I've lost the thread with drawing. That's the default? Huh. I didn't know that was the default. Do you know what? If no one else joins, I will join on my other one. But that will be a bit insane. Oh, I'm a fucking idiot. I've just got rid of Xerneas and saved Tapu Fini on my account.
I thought you were saying you saved Xerneas on my account.
You have Xerneas saved.
Good point.
I lost Xerneas and saved Tapu Fini for no reason. Well, I'm going to join on mine now.
Ramsey, did you make sure to go online? So when you're on the main menu, yeah, pressing Y and pressing plus, make sure you're online before trying to do the code stuff.
Oh, I'd love some. Thank you. Just water's good for me. Thank you. Yeah, so the going online thing is always the bit that I forget, the first one, and I'm like, oh. That would be it. Nice. Lads, my phone just made the loudest sound. People just want to talk to me right now. Like, people won't talk to me for ages then. It'd be like, no, we all want to talk to you in the same 5 minutes. Oh, will she get in time? You've got 45 seconds.
Should I?
Yeah, you should have plenty of time.
We have to add tension because we're entertainers.
And also, I was here alone.
Yes, you go. Watch
Thank
us.
You.
Jiggle. And then, take the seat.
Hello.
Hello.
Was that better?
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
Hey! Let's go. Everyone.
Let's go, lads.
Ready up, lads. We're going in.
Yes!
Don't worry.
Yeah, of course.
We'll wait and play.
As I said, we're on random, right? We're on random. When we have enough people here... Oh, there's some more Pico and everything. Yeah. No, it's fine. When there's enough people here, I just won't hop in.
Yeah. I'll pass taking the ride on. That's fair. Oh, we got Togemaru and more Peko.
Yes.
Cute squad. And taking it.
Oh, Mindchow.
And Mindchow. One
so
of my favourites.
Cute squad and Rhydon.
Also apparently competitive.
Cute squad.
Mindchow's getting used right now.
Cute squad and Rhydon.
I don't know if I call Mindchow cute, but I do love it.
He's pretty.
Cute squad is good. Right, what have we got at the other side? We have Bug.
Hmm.
Andy, what Bug legendaries are there?
But where do you want to go then?
We want
Alpacs
left,
chosen.
I'd say. Because bug is weak to ice and rock. So if we go that path, we should be fine. Genesect is where I went instantly. But the thing is, I didn't think Genesect was in this Ultra Beast. I don't know if they're... Oh, is... Leggy. Is Leggy bug?
Leggy?
Andy will know what I mean by Leggy. Swole or kick lady.
Buzzwole?
Buzzwole. It could be Buzzwole or it's kick or Leggy lady.
Buzzwole is a nightmare.
Buzzwole is a nightmare.
Leggy.
Yeah, I think it's...
Why are Armaldo's eyes off the side of his head?
I don't know, but he's got a little cute face like a crow.
Leggy.
Cool.
Not G-Max Grimmsnarl, who is also Leggy.
You forgot Leggy Bug's name. I forgot Leggy Bug's name too. Do I go big and just max lightning things?
Go big or go home?
Yeah, we max lightning, yes.
Look at tiny little Togedemaru. He's so cute.
I absolutely love this squad we got. So...
And Rhydon. Sorry, Alpax.
God. Andy, do you know what type Leggy Bug is? Because, like...
Is it bug?
It's bug. It's got. They're all double type though, but it will be bug. Buzzwole is bug fighting.
He's awful.
And bug fighting does actually lead us to a problem, which is I'm weak to fighting, and so is Alpax.
Fighting. Yeah. Did you open the link that Ramsey sent on your phone?
Yeah.
You opened it, and it's still open.
It is.
Awesome. Just so I can have a look at it later.
Sure.
Thank you. Because I don't have to bother...
Fine. Andy's fighting, so I'm going to go look at the bug.
Cool.
Ultra Beast. So, yeah, it will probably... I think we're right, and it's one of those two. I actually kind of want it now to be Genesect, and we learn that Genesect's in the game, just so Mam can just come in and dab in and be like, called it!
Yes!
Ultra Beast... Leggy?
That's not going to work, surely.
Ultra Beast Leggy
Angie.
Images. He Angie! It did not work.
I love Morpeko so much. I love that last time we did this, we taught Ramsey about Morpeko. And she was like, oh, it's so cute. And we were like, just waiting. He Angie. And that was one of the best times of my life. Like, the first time I saw Morpeko, I was filled with such joy. He's still trying to find Leggy Bug.
Right. Here we go. I've got a list of them on.
Well, that was shocking.
Saint Morpeko. I absolutely love that. Why this page a second ago had? Yep, catch for me. Yes, we are.
You're welcome.
Right. Pheromosa.
Show me.
Leggy. So
I hate it.
I'm not a big fan of it either. So apparently both of the bugs that we can encounter are bug fighting. So we need to get off of the dark and the rock typing that we have because both of those are weak.
So you and Alpax need to swap.
Yeah, at some point. Bug resists at least. So Muir Alpax wants to take this. He's stayed with his. So I'll grab this for now.
But Morpeko, cute spot.
I miss him already. But... It's risky. But the problem is now we actually don't want to go down ice because apparently we're going to be weak to ice too. Oh, Andy, you need change too, don't you? You're electric steel. God! Bad squad! Fairy's good.
What is that?
It's Clefable.
Also, it is.
It resists and is super effective against fighting.
Okay.
Now, I think it's neutralized in the grand scheme of things. But... Because I think bug resists fairy or fairy resists bug. I don't remember which way around it is.
That's worrying.
I'm now in pure like on the fly strategizing because like I thought I was safe in the route we're going. Then it's gonna be Genesect. It's just gonna be fucking bug steel, and I'm not gonna know what to do. Also, I feel like I'm playing with Luke narrations cheating. I know everything.
He really does. This is why I'm saying, like, I can be really lazy and not having to learn anything about Pokemon. Because I can very much just go to Luke. Hey, what do I want against this?
Thank you for following Caleb TMBV2. Hello!
Hey, welcome, Caleb. How you doing? Thank you for following.
We really appreciate it.
I'm assuming someone wants to play.
if you want in. We're on the second fight of this particular raid. Andy, use a steel move. Thank you. And then, yeah, there'll be space in the next one if you want in. Right, back on my massive train of thought. I do not know what we can really do on this particular rundown, which is going to be super good against what we're up against. I'm happy that Alpac's just found a Rhydon and he's like, I like this. I like this Rhydon.
I like him. He's chonky.
Follow me. That's fine. Follow me makes you attack that one Pokemon.
And then that's what you want
to
do.
We were going to be doing that anyway. Good, nice Vivi animation. Don't care if you join. You're here, chill. Nice.
Cool. Nice.
We're really following that Vivi animation.
Feel free to just chill. Yeah, we love that. It's really cool.
Nine is probably both of our favourite Final Fantasies. You know I say this now.
I love you.
I love you
too.
Well,
Final Fantasy 9 is my favourite game.
He's the only cute Final Fantasy. We're going to have a fight, sir.
Oh, fighting. We're fighting. I mean, I suppose with mainline characters, he is
the cutest.
So, I'll give you that. He loves Quinner so much, but Quinner is a bit weird. You have to admit. You just love him.
Yeah.
I'm literally like, looking around. I have so many Final Fantasy.
We are just 9 away from the 300, yeah. We are.
We're getting there. We hoped yesterday was going to be a little busier, but we are getting there and we're really happy about that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, at 300 followers, we are going to be making our flat in The Sims. Us and our flat in The Sims, because we really, really want to play The Sims.
Well, I was wondering, people don't necessarily need to see us play with, you know, the eyebrow shape and the noses for 4 million years on stream. So we could make us pre-stream and then just build the flat on stream and, like, play a bit of The Sims. But we'll talk about it.
He's also, don't at me, but he's a midget. He's not a midget. He's like 9.
He's canonically 9 years old.
Yeah, so he's not a midget. He's just short. He's like, he's a child.
He's small.
Like, yeah, no. Like, we are obsessed that game, and we have the guidebook, which has all the canonical ages and stuff in it, but...
All sort of faces, but then stream with clothing choices. Yeah, clothing choices, absolutely. But I was also thinking, fair. I don't necessarily want to make my body on the stream. You know? Because I don't want... You know? Yeah, or, fair. Like, have them be in undies or whatever. That'd just be super weird.
I get that. I hadn't thought about that.
I just find that a bit strange. Okay. So I was like, we could just make, like, the basics of the character.
Midget in your dictionary means short.
Fair. It's actually a slur, isn't it?
It's ableist language.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
But yeah, he is short, but Eiko is shorter than him in 9. She's the
she's 6!
She's the shortest character, yeah.
Like, so yeah.
But I'm just saying that he's not the shortest character.
Smaller boy. Cool. Alpac's taking that, which is probably the best play
I could grab the book and tell you his height.
It has Meteor Beam and Cosmic Power, which is nice. Meteor Beam is like one of my new favourite Pokemon moves I've discovered recently. 2 turns, but you get a special attack buff on the first turn you use it.
Mm.
And then another attack later. Fuck, what do we want here? Probably the grass? Grass is a support Pokemon on the right.
Alpac
I believe it's
and
a
Blossom. Andy don't wait for you.
Nah, they're on it. Well, it's because I said earlier we're going rock. But that's no longer the correct play, I think. I think the grass is the right move now.
Well, let's see. You went grass.
Nice. And that way, if Andy wants to take a double swap, he can take this one as well. I'm just saying that aloud so he hears it. I'm going to wait, because if he doesn't, I might. He's going to take it. Cool. Because I believe that's Blossom, right? It looks like it could be Blossom.
I can't really tell.
But usually the grass Pokemon are more likely to be a support Pokemon, which is interesting. You haven't finished Final Fantasy.
Could be Cherrim. I think that's Cherrim.
Oh, you might be right. And Andy got a water Pokemon against it. We're screwed.
I haven't even finished an FF game waiting for the 10 games and 13 games to arrive on Game Pass. And I'm also excited for Dragon Quest XI Definitive Edition to come out on Xbox Game Pass. Cool.
I know there's a version of Dragon Quest XI on Game Pass.
Really, I really recommend 10. 13 is Cherrim.
You're right.
Blossom Dance is a lot more. 13, I find fine. A lot of people don't like it.
Yeah.
That's
what I've heard about as well.
But I still think it's fun. Cherrim is adorable.
This isn't even its final form.
Yeah, this is the second good Cherrim. You know? But I like... I like Cherubi better.
Hmm. Yeah. Cherubi is the pre-evolution. It's just two cherries. It's cute.
Just little cherries with faces and they're very cute. But you'll see It transforms, doesn't it? On
If it uses a sunny move. Okay. If it uses sunny day, it will. Mams asked if other FF games appeared on Xbox. So,
yes.
Since 13, they've been cross-platform.
A bunch of the like PS1 ones are already on the Games Pass.
Yeah, so there's the Xbox Live Game Pass and the eStore and stuff, and a lot of the remasters are now cross console, so they're on everything. And you can definitely play 9, 8, and 8 on the Games Pass.
And 7, I think.
I think 7, I'm not sure about 7 for sure. Because I'm when we sat down to
but
play.
But even though I own it in physical copy like 3 times and on every other platform, I did buy 9 on Switch. Even though I have no intention of playing it on Switch.
FF7, 8, 9 and the remasters 10, 12 are on the current generation of Xbox, I'd say.
But I really like 12. I'd say it's more of an acquired taste than some of the other Final Fantasy.
Actually, now I think about it, I don't think you can get 30 on the current generations of Xbox.
I don't know.
Which I hadn't thought about thinking of that.
Well, 13 was the first Final Fantasy to release on Xbox.
Yeah.
As it did a dual release. But it had it was on one disc for the PS3 and on 2 discs for the 360.
Yeah.
Fuck 360.
I love you. It was one of the first Final Fantasy games that I bought. Because my brother bought X and X2.
Suck it, my Xbox first. Fans. me and my partner at the time, he was an Xbox person, I was a PlayStation version, and I was like, fuck you, 2 discs. Bay, your logic there is the main reason I still watch Lord of the Rings on VHS. Fair.
Alpax has decided to become a sacrifice.
FF13 is backwards compatible. What?
Oh, the PS used Blu-rays while it's passed in. That's fair.
Yeah. All the 13 games are backwards compatible. It's not about whether the games are backwards compatible. It's about whether the consoles are backwards compatible.
Yeah. Right? I think if you have the discs, you can play them on all the ones. I believe with Xbox, they did a thing where they, in essence, patched in backwards compatibility.
Right, so all the Xbox consoles are backwards compatible now.
But specifically to specific games, because they patched in, I believe the way they did it was like they released backwards compatibility, but they released it staggered with certain games.
Oh, weird.
This is just bad.
Xbox downloads the right version when you put in the disc. Mm-hmm. Huh.
That's it.
That's cool. Extended edition on DVD and OG Blu-rays, don't know if newer is the same. Extended editions were on 2 discs. VHS was thick boy and held the whole thing in 1 tape.
Okay, so is it leggy or beefy?
Since Xbox One, you can play a ton of Xbox 360 games on Xbox One and Series X.
Yes, but the way
really
they
cool.
do it
really
is
cool.
rather than... It's Buzzwole.
It's Buzzwole, I told you. He's a nightmare, but TSP loves him.
So the way that the Xbox do backwards compatibility is rather than them being like...
What the fuck is that?
It's Swole, and it's a buzz. It goes buzz and it's Swole as fuck.
I just really fucking... What? I just love reading what y'all are saying. Hench. This is giving me joy. Hench. So... I was going to say he was on a stream. He wasn't.
No, he wasn't.
We did a private session ages ago with Andy and Danny, and Dora just joined the call. She's hijacked the call for a bit, and we said, we're fighting something called Buzzwall. Google it. You'll love it. Mm. And she was like, he's my new boyfriend.
And then goes, wahoo, am I too late? No, we were still going for about
an hour. Yeah. You can play Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind Xbox Series X. That's really cool.
But yeah, so the way that they do backwards compatibility is rather than being like the consoles can read the discs, consoles will in essence go, yeah, we got a patch for that. It's on the cloud somewhere. We'll just download the game now you can play it.
I hate him so much.
He's kind of funny though. I love the way, like, so my favourite thing about him, right, in case you haven't noticed, when he gets hit, he flexes. Watch.
Yeah, he does. I know he does, but I hate him.
Andy, 5 on the scale shot. I love it.
I hate his face.
Got little sunglasses though.
They're not sunglasses. They're his mistake eyes. When I get hit, I flex.
I'm gonna try that.
What is that?
Like, I'm loving chat. Just be like,
what the fuck? He's called Buzzwall, and he is awful.
Nice hit. That was a good hit.
Hits the silent planet. You gotta flex.
It's silent planet. Her husband's glacier eyes comes in to punch back.
There's people joining the other Discord server we're in. I come back and see whatever that is. Yeah, enjoy your nightmares.
I don't hate Buzzwool.
Why? You're afraid of all bugs.
I am terrified of insects. This is a genuine truth about me.
TSP, my husbando. Wait, you're cheating on Glacier Eyes. I'm sure he'd be flattered after seeing that.
I am so into this thing. It's so bad.
Ugh, he keeps avoiding me. No, no, I must kill it. He can exist. I just don't want him to exist near me. You know?
What's your favourite Ultra Beast? Either Nihilego or Blacephalon.
Oh, Nihilego, full stop.
Like, Nihilego is so cute, and Blacephalon is like my aesthetic, where it's like clowny and stuff like that.
He's a jellyfish.
Special place for, special runners up for Stack Attacker, because then I have a shiny one.
But he has muscles. The Wasp Bee story haunted me after I heard it.
Oh, one of the reasons I'm scared of bugs is I got a wasp stuck in my hair. My hair is very curly and long, got stuck in the back of it, and I wound up getting stung like 9 times in the back of the neck, and it hurt, unsurprisingly. Cortana or Nihilego, because Nihilego looks like a Pokemon Lily. Yeah. Well,
yeah, just be with Machamp. He's less freaky than
Good protect. You actually
Cortana, what a choice. I love Cortana.
Cortana is cute.
But I like shiny.
Yeah, same thing happened to you and your wasp when you were a kid. It's not nice.
Luke, same thing happened to me when I was a kid. Not fun. You won't be going for a neck tattoo anytime soon.
Mm. I like Lily in the anime, yeah.
I wouldn't have a neck tattoo only because my neck is short.
Mm-hmm. Not fun. Yeah. Like, I liked Lily. Sun and Moon were really good games. They had decent they had decent things.
I've never been stung. And the thought of it really scares me.
Oh, I forget about Poiple.
It's just Discord.
I know, I'm just swiping it away. I always forget about Poiple and... Poiple. And the big needle boy.
What colour's your shirt? Poiple.
It's Poiple! I'm from New York and it's Poiple! Yeah, new Cobalt really like Poiple. What's the big one called? It sounds like needle. It's Poiple!
Sorry.
You having fun? Yeah. So the whole point, one of the things, the general theories about the Ultra Beast, I've never played Ultra Sun or Moon, so I don't know if anything was ever confirmed, was they are all vaguely designed to look like or represent a character in the game. So they all look like some of the people.
Mm.
I don't remember who Buzzwool is supposed to be, but there are characters that kind of look like the things. I don't know. I know this is a running theory. One second, let me see.
British people, when they see a microchip, microcrisps. Ha ha. We did it first. America came after us.
We started you!
Like, why does America think it has such big dick energy when it's literally a child?
Oh. I love it. Like, it's like a toddler squaring up to you.
We're taking away your independence again.
We'll take our tea back, thank you.
We stole the tea in the first place. Let's not start that row.
I know.
Crisp is much more representative of the product than chips. Chips are much more representative than fries. Microchips are a thing by McCain. Yes.
Apparently, oh my God.
My mum still likes microchips. It's a weird thing, when she's ill, she'll be like, oh, I just want a sandwich and some microchips. As like, that's just like a comfort thing.
You're fair.
Have you ever had microchips in your life? Do you even know what they are?
Nope.
Right, you get a little box. Right.
Oh, those, yes!
And you shake them up.
Yep. I've never had them, but I've seen them.
No, of course you haven't had them.
Sorry, I need one very important thing before we go any further. Fighto!
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 Microwave chips. Keep explaining. I don't know what they are. Oh, right. You get a box. It says microchips on it. You rip open the top and the inside is like silver reflective-y, like foil or something. I don't know the exact thing. You put the box in the microwave and because of the silver reflective stuff, it cooks them really hot and they're usually... The definitive ones are the microchips that are crinkled. They're cool. And then you season them in the box and you shake the box up to season them. And you just get a little box of chips. It's cool. I think your dad would really combust, Luke.
He would.
He would. I know what you mean now. I've never had them. They're cool.
By the way,
they're very quick junk food.
We lost.
Like a minute. It's like a minute in the microwave.
We lost. The buzz wall beat us.
Oh my god. Lads.
No buzz wall for us.
He was too hench. I blame Luke.
It's fair.
Had them once or twice when I was wee. Yeah, they're very much like, oh god, what can we feed the child in like a quick thing?
No shiny here. I'm taking the
favorite. But my mom just has a weird fascination with them when she's not very well. And she'll just have like a sandwich and a little wee box of microchips. Because you only get like fucking 6 chips in there or something.
Yeah. Right, let's set up the next one, shall we?
Damn. Yeah.
Well then,
lads, everyone get ready.
I can't believe.
Ooh,
do we want a rematch?
No, don't get rid of Xerneas. Oh my god.
Do you want to do a Xerneas one?
Well, no, because I think there's plenty of people, so I won't hop in again.
That's fair.
I think my family's similar to Luke's in regards to junk food. So my mum and dad are, but will do takeaways or bits and bobs of junk food, especially because we've been quite unfortunate.
No, I didn't say that.
With some serious incidents or chronic illnesses in my family, and we had to adjust just to be like, look, I'm doing so much already. I'm not now standing for 2 hours and, you know, making a fucking chef meal, right? So my mum and dad can be very like that, but we had to adjust. Because I was a carer for like a year, like very full time, 24-hour a day, and I was like, I am not cooking really complex things. So like, it wasn't like microchips. I'm not saying I went that bad on it, but I did learn a lot of faster recipes and stuff that would freeze, so that I didn't have to
freezeable
cook
meals
every day.
Like one, I am such a big fan
and
of.
And anyone who's had a child knows about being a 24-hour carer, and will suddenly go, "Yeah, we don't have time to cook something fresh every meal every day."
Freezeable meals are the hero here. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I love creating something huge and then freezing it, and then like we do that for streaming because we'll be like, right, if we stream in the afternoon, we start at 2:30 our time, then we'll get off around 6 and we'll be like, right, it's dinner, but we're both tired from streaming, so you just want to like,
yeah,
cook.
And I mean, this is very much in comparison to some of the stuff we're talking about, our thing is like not as much of a problem because we have the time, we're then just tired. But yeah, it was just a thing where we did have to adjust the way we view food. And you know what? There's nothing wrong with it. Because being able to cook, right, every day and buy a lot of fresh ingredients all the time is hugely privileged. I wish it wasn't, but it is. And a lot of people have had to live on, you know, cheaper or junk food because that's what they need to do to survive. If Andy's not joining it, I will hop in this. What raid is this?
Random.
Random?
Yeah.
I'll jump in. If no one else is gonna.
Smelly Andy. Run away.
I think he was just trying to be nice.
No, he's got, I know, he's being polite. He's got his shiny. The first shiny, no, the second shiny we caught on raid, right? Oh, Andy joined.
That's fine, bitch.
Let's go! Go, 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 go!
Like how I went, that's fine, bitch. When I broke my leg, my parents came up with 20 Tupperware boxes of frozen tomato sauces for pasta and chili con carne since I wasn't able to cook. That's amazing. The quick roasting tin book. Ah, do we have the same book, Ramsay?
Do they know that they
come in jars? Yeah, this is the thing. Like, while that's really nice because it is healthier, right? A lot of people just don't have the time, money, or whatever.
Steal.
To do that stuff.
Could be Dialga, could be a lot of things. We probably want to go.
I am dying at mom though, saying, do they know those come in jars?
Left and right, then doesn't matter what we're doing the last one.
That is a big steely boy. He is very
big. Wait till you see what he is without the thing.
Duraldon?
No, it's not Duraldon.
Who is it?
It's...
No, he's pointier, isn't he?
Yes.
Who is this?
Copperajah.
Oh my god, you're gonna love him. You're gonna love him. No, you'll love him. Him!
It's a very square elephant. Like, it's just a cube.
If you are able to afford to bulk buy, it's cheaper to cook yourself. Yes. If you can bulk buy, then everything becomes really cheap. But not everyone can afford to bulk buy. Like, some people literally live week to week, you know?
Yeah. It's the elephant that killed you. Yes.
It's the freaking Ellie that killed me.
Nelly the elephant packed her trunk and said goodbye to the alpacs.
Nelly the elephant kicked our backs and said goodbye because he's dead now. Oh dear. Yeah, that's why I said if able to buy. I mean, if you are able to buy, it's the best thing to do.
Elephant versus pig. Who wins? Let's find out next time on Dragon Ball Z.
I got enough stuff to make us a shit ton of soup this week, by the way. Luke made ramen a few days ago, which is really good, so we've got some frozen ramen in. And I make a really... Well, I kind of invented it from another recipe, but I make a nice...
leaking potato soup.
Well, it's not leaking potato. It's not like a cream one. Nah. It's like chunky. It's a chunky one with a tomato-y, vegetable-y broth. But it's really nice.
Let me to just start the debate.
Some crunchy bread.
Chunky soup.
Or blend, cream,
creamy
or,
soup.
Or thick blended soup.
Chunky soup. Chunky.
I like both.
Chunky.
And I only like chunky soup if I make it.
Get out.
So yeah, I think I'm a creamy soup.
Chunky soup.
Creamy soup is safe. Chunky soup is dangerous for textures.
Chunky.
Listen, did you hear what I said?
Yeah, dangerous for textures. Which is fair.
Thank you.
It's an adventure in every bite. My favorite soup is Scotch broth, which is like barley, vegetables, and ham.
I've never had it.
I mean, no surprise.
What about watery bits? Watery with bits. You're making it sound so appetizing. I like noodle soup, to be fair.
Yeah.
Noodle soup is good.
I will defer to noodles.
My best soup does require blending. What is it? Jay loves lentil soup, but it gives him the fart.
Runs in the family. Oh, wait. Lentils make me fart. Most foods make me fart. Like.
Yeah, I know this.
Chicken noodle is good. Oh, tomato and red pepper. Nice.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, Colin Skink is so good.
Farty choke soup is the one.
Farty choke.
Oh my god. I've been making homemade lentil and it's banging. Not homemade lentil soup. Just one singular homemade lentil.
Lentils are plants,
he's
right?
He's grown a single lentil.
Lentils
and
are
he's very proud
plants,
of
plants, right? It is a plant-based thing. What does it look like?
Is chili a soup?
No, chili is not.
Chili is not a soup. Chili is a chili.
Chili is a chili. Some food substance. What are lentils? I know what they are. I want to see what they look like on, like, a, like if they grow a plant or something.
I love that he's just googled what are lentils. Gonna dab out now. Bake Off finale is now to watch. So I've got date night with Lou. Fair enough. Go and enjoy.
It's not. It's got body press, which makes it good for someone to take. I'm not gonna bother with it, but I need to get off my Pokemon at some point.
What separates chili in a chili soup, which is thick? Well, you wouldn't just sit and eat a chili, as like without stuff. So
lentils look like peas. Like
yeah,
big,
lentils
like
are
peas. Bean pods.
Lentils are legumes, are they not? Mm-hmm. My guy has crap pee-pee.
fire.
A soup is generally a liquid. A chili, I think, is just considered chongy enough to be a solid. Or several solid. Lentils are legumes.
Who did this? Who did this?
Yeah, who would do that?
Who did this?
Alpacs did. Yeah, like peanuts. Peanuts are legumes.
Fire. Oh, yeah, of course you. Fire. Fire!
Don't just yell fire. That's worrying. Everyone evacuates our building.
Yeah! I did not think about that.
What time are we on?
Yeah. 25:10.
Don't forget, lads, because I'm reminding you as well. Be reading Octo at the end of the stream.
Thanks for reminding me, I've forgotten.
I knew you had.
They're very smart. Yep, so if people want to stick around, if anyone wants to play some Smash, we'll be just jumping in there.
Is he playing Smash? You're saying that as if we know he's playing Smash.
That was one of his live ops.
Wait, it doesn't just go with majority vote? Yeah, it should do. But if there was a 50-50, then it means the other two people...
My mum just texted her about the photos and I'm upset.
Did one of you say it?
I'll be very upset.
Pip or Sam must have said it.
I'll be very upset when my brother will be there.
Oh, I'm so happy.
Wait, it doesn't...
he dead.
It doesn't just go with majority vote. It does go with majority vote, but it randomises on a 50-50. So someone else must press grass and they won the 50-50. Or three of you did. In which case, grr.
Doesn't matter. Ignore Angilu.
This mode involves a lot of strategizing. Pips Copperasha uses knuckles. It doesn't have knuckles. He has elephant toes.
Yeah, you'd think it would just show a hoof.
Gonna hoof it.
Actually, yeah, what is an elephant's foot? It's just a foot, right? It's not anything.
Yeah, I think it's a foot. I believe it's a foot.
Are you okay?
Yeah, why?
You're bleeding.
Huh?
Yeah.
That's only a little bit.
Did you scratch yourself?
It'll be a spot or something. Yeah.
Did you just scratch really hard?
Yeah, I've also been trying to not bite my nails as much recently, so my nails are getting longer than I'm used to.
They are not long, lads.
They're not. They're not, but they're not like...
Inverted.
They're not like, yeah, inverted nails. Who bounced?
Toe knuckles.
By Alpacs.
Elephant foot. Yeah.
Okay, I remember that struggle. I'm just trying. That's why I'm trying to get back into the habit of regularly painting my nails.
I will never stop biting my nails, I don't think. But we both painted our nails today. That was nice. Luke just got some nail varnish out and I went, go on, pick me one and chuck me it. Because I have not painted my nails in months. You have. You've been doing yours.
I've been trying to get back into the habit of it. Alpine said I saw a gif of an elephant which was given a prosthetic leg. And it was very cool. That's so cute.
Aww.
I'm very okay with it.
Oh, it was on front page of Reddit today. Ramsey thing.
That means we can hunt it down and look at the cute.
Did you close the thing that I wanted you to keep open from Ramsey?
Shit, I did.
Yeah, I knew you fucking would.
Sorry.
You bugger. I'll look it up later. He's finding it in the chat. I can't. Don't worry.
It's not there. But I'll pop it in Discord. Thank you.
Love you. Thank you.
I accidentally pressed run. He's like, no.
I've been painting with clear base coats because I need something. You can't paint them for work, can you?
No. I need to get myself a proper base coat because they just peel off of me.
He's been doing interesting things where he'll wash the dishes. He got away with not washing up tonight because I said, yeah, I'll do it in the morning because he'd just done his nails and then went, oh shit, I shouldn't have done that. And I was like,
just in my
leave
nails.
The washing up then. We didn't have too much washing up tonight, no. Though, so it's fine.
And I cooked.
What did I do today?
Everything else.
Wasn't what I was going to say.
But it's the right answer, isn't it?
I cleaned the bathroom yesterday. I did all the recabling and the dusting. I did two lots of washing today. So I'm basically a housewife, lads. I don't know when this happened. He's just... You're just you.
Yeah, I'm just me. I'll take the grapevine, I guess. No, refused.
Well, you chuckled, and that was my intention.
Refused. I'm taking the grapevine.
That's Craig, overgrown. He's too tall.
It is late again.
Are you disappearing, man? Grapevine is brick break, and you doubted the choice.
I did doubt the choice, and I still do. Yup. Bye.
Fair enough. Nighty night. Oh.
Our dehumidifier
turned off. We use it to dry our washing.
Dabbed out.
Dab.
One dab's in, one dab's out.
I didn't dab. I just did this. That's not anything.
Gerbil.
Hi, baby. Oh, bye, baby. So, because we're wanting to fit a raid in, we'll probably sit and talk to Octo for like 10 minutes. Do we want to do one more?
One more after this? This does not matter in a way. We probably go rock here because rock has a high chance, like has a decent chance of having ground type moves in it, which is something at least. Oh, and this has a fighting move. I know what it is. I think. No, that's Armaldo. It's not Tyrantrum, but it's still fine. It still has a ground type move. And berries afterwards. Oh,
that's nice.
Yeah, berries afterwards.
Always nice.
Berries.
You okay, Blinky? You feeling a bit tired?
My eyes are watering, actually.
Is it the big bright light?
It's the big bright light.
Scram. Armaldo is interesting, isn't he?
So he's the partner Pokemon to Cradley.
What do you mean?
So Fossil Pokemon come in sets of two.
Oh, I don't think I knew that.
Normally. So in the original it was like Kabuto and Omastar. And then...
Yeah, I knew that.
The others. Then it was these two. And then... Yeah, so the Fossil Pokemon usually come in pairs, right? Mm. And, you know, you can only pick one of the two.
What's the one before Omastar?
Kabuto. Sorry. No, it's... Omanyte, Omastar, Kabuto, Kabutops.
So I like...
Yeah, there's no Gen 2 fossils.
I like Omanyte.
Mm-hmm. And then...
It's cute. But Omastar's got the weird mouth.
Yeah. The mouth is weird. Like, but I just hate... Like, I love fossil Pokemon. Like, and in general, I love all fossil Pokemon.
I would have thought that you'd hate Kabuto.
Kabuto's... alright, I just hate horseshoes. Gen 4 got Bastion and Kranidos, which are amazing, and I love them.
Got what? Bastiodon?
Bastiodon. It's a giant, like, fortress. It's got a giant face.
A giant face?
Gen 5, Karakostan, Archeops. Gen 6 was Tyrantrum and Amora. What's the Pterodactyl one? That'll be Aerodactyl.
Aerodactyl is a great name for a Pterodactyl Pokemon. I'm just saying.
It is good. And Aerodactyl's also great. And then there's this one, which has mistakes. Gen 7 didn't have any. There were no fossils in Sun and Moon. And then last but not least, there's this game, which has the half-breed fossils, the half-and-half fossils, which are weird. But, like, in general, like, I love all fossil Pokemon. I actually quite like the fossils from this game. They grew on me because they're weird abominations that no one else loves, and that's my aesthetic all over. Like, you know I love weird things that, like, no one loves.
I know, but I'm a bit offended.
Everyone loves you.
Fuck off.
They come to watch you, not me. Nice one.
Don't be silly.
Then fossils wrong, they need to evolve. Like, yeah. The fossils in this game are genuinely actually hilarious. They have that...
I hate them.
Well,
I'm
none
sorry.
Of them, none of them should be alive. Like, one of them is, like, the fastest thing on land. But... only lives in the ocean. Like, it can't run on water on land, but it's the fastest
thing.
It
can't breathe on land.
Yeah, and it's the fastest creature alive. They're all evolutionary mistakes, and I'm just like, fucking mood, sir.
Now I relate. I'm an evolutionary mistake, too.
Right! Thank you! They're very sympathetic when you realize they're trying their hardest, but, like, fuck them. If someone wants this, it's not a bad shout. That's why they died out. Yeah, exactly. And we brought them back to torture them and make them fight for our entertainment. Andy, do you want it? Andy, take it if you want it. Andy. 3, 2. You didn't try it. It was too late.
Oh.
I gave him a chance.
It doesn't always update very fast,
no, I know.
Though.
Berries. My berries.
I found my birdies.
Okay, this might be a tough one, depending on what it is.
So, what do you think it is?
I think it's Celesteela. It's Celesteela or Dialga are the most two likely choices.
Okay. How bad do you want it to be neither, Chad?
Why ditch Grovyle? Because that's a flying steel-type Pokemon, and Grovyle was weak to it, and fighting is resisted.
To be fair, he's kind of cool. I just don't like his weird spindly neck.
Berries and cream, berries and cream. I quite like Celesteela. I don't know, we just run some berries. Yeah. This was the correct move because now I at least have this. Just be careful because ground moves do not hit this. Celesteela is a difficult fight. Celesteela's,
I like Celesteela.
It's a competitive
cool.
Pokemon. People do use it because it's a really bulky Pokemon. Mm. But
he's got them Rayman arms though.
Yeah. I like the fact that the top of them look like bamboo. The arms.
Oh, the way that they're caught.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have the Skyscraper Dragon! Why is it Skyscraper?
It's such a weird thing. Do you think they ran out of ideas for him?
They've ran out of ideas every generation. Every generation has a couple Pokemon you're like, why are you here?
Yeah, they really do, don't they?
Like Voltorb and Electrode, just like, we make Pokemon, we turn upside down.
I'm alright with that. I think that's funny.
Yeah, so do I. I like Voltorb and Electrode.
They're a bit angy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I don't like, even if some of them are cute, I don't like Pokemon that are just items, really. The Pokeball is the exception, like Electrode and Thingy are the... what word am I looking for?
Exception.
Thank you. I kept trying to say excuse. Because they are an item created by Pokemon. But like, Klefki, which is just a ring of keys.
It's just car keys.
Like, no. Oh, my dude is not great here.
Like, this is a tough one for us. We didn't get a lot of good things for it. If you have a ground-type move, you can use it now. I used a move called Smackdown last turn, which means that it's grounded. So keep an eye on ground moves, because it can negate that at some point. But can it get multiple? Oh, I thought it could get multiples up, and that would be really scary.
Yeah, it would.
Just keep an eye on if you have any ground moves, whether or not it says super effective or not. But yeah, Celesteela is competitive because it's so tanky.
It's the alarms.
Well, much hard, very fight, wow. We lost the last one. Don't pretend like they're losable. But to be fair, Alpac's just saying, hey, you like me. Alpac's just walking up, getting his rabbit to walk up to Celesteela and just like, hey.
Oh, that was nice.
Yeah.
Oh, you guys have got this.
The Duraludon has carried this. There's a neutralize. Now, I don't know if this makes it my Smackdown effect go, but I feel like it might. This is what I was worried it had. Okay.
Ouchie.
Celesteela use Flash Cannon.
Ooh.
Fire Baldo.
Bye, I guess.
Yeah. Celesteela's one of the ones I would like to
see in
shiny.
What's well, it like, shiny?
I don't know for sure. It is attack up. Okay, I thought it would get defense up. It's honestly getting a defense up here is better than getting attack up.
See you later.
Sorry, yeah, an attack up is getting better than getting defense up because we don't want it to resist. And it's used Flash
he's
Cannon.
Small now.
I guess Earthquake's affected by physical. So Earthquake going up in damage is bad for us because it could easily kill. Copperajah at this point, and it could potentially do a good damage to both the others on a crit with a stat up.
Fighter, I'll say it for you, you bitch.
Thank you. Oh, that's fine. We healed. That's the best one.
That's nice, actually. Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially because the thingy was nearly dead.
That should mean that the Lot Bunny would survive. I feel like Copperajah still dies to Earthquake here, but
we'll find out.
It's interesting. We could kill it with the Thunderbolt. Yay, we got it. Cool. I'm casting from the couch because I'm dead.
You're doing what?
Casting.
Casting couch. Dumbass.
Like live casting, like.
Yes.
Commentary.
Yeah, that was a difficult one, but I thought you had it just because of the Duraludon's damage, honestly.
Yeah, do we save this? I know you like them. You've got Xerneas saved, so I can drop Xerneas.
No,
off.
I don't have Xerneas saved.
Oh, do you not?
No.
Oh, you actually lost it.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm not worried. Do you have a Landorus?
No.
Okay.
Because I'm shiny
then
hunting
no,
Landorus.
Then no, don't worry. Don't save it. We'll find it again at some point.
We'll find it. It's clenching, honestly. We still have 3 lives, which was good. It's just one stray earthquake could have messed us up. Provile, Armaldo, Celesteela. Nope. None of it's shiny.
Oh, it's so pretty in that color.
It's such a good color. I really like Celesteela. But yeah, it's a decent spread for those things as well. Like, Ultra Beasts are just good.
Who are you taking? Big chunky elephant?
Nellyphant. Nelly the Nellyphant. Nellyphant, 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 Nellyphant.
Right then, lads. Shall we let chat pick what they want the last one to be from what you've got?
Sure. We have a choice for random or we have a choice.
Don't. There we go.
Yeah, I know. You got some chores to do, but you can keep watching, see what I'm playing, so you're back in.
Oh, fair enough. Well, I think this is just the last one we were going to do, so...
I do Blacephalon's last one.
Luke would like to do Blacephalon, which is the weird...
clown thing.
...jester boy. So, what have you got? Can you just click on it so that people...
Andy, you're heading off too? There's one last one!
Alright, see you later. Everyone's just like, no, we will not do your last
one. Tapfini, Landorus, or Xerneas are our options.
Or random.
Or Blacephalon.
So sorry. I'm setting that up then. No problem.
Alpax, wanna come fight a clown with us?
If we don't get any requests, then I'll let you get your Blacephalon, I guess.
I'm just happy. Oh, but I don't have any space for it to get myself to go around.
Yeah, but I can
Alpax says sure, whatever. Right. Everything's fine. Let's go. It's the same code as always. It will just
let me set. Well, you. There you go. Right, okay, lobby's up, guys. I've just set it up this time.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
I'm just excited to go give Octo his cash.
Yeah, I think that'll be fun.
It'll be nice.
Do we want to wait? I don't think there's anyone else around because I think Ramsay's popped away. I think most people have gone to bed advised now.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's a good start, to be completely honest.
All right, let's just go then.
Let's go. Quick one. Speed run. So, Blacephalon is fire ghost. So, we want water, ghost, dark, rock. There's loads of weaknesses to it. So, it's a good one to fight. Okay.
Take all, do you know? Double life, do.
What? We could. I'll take the pincurch in here.
But I like...
I like
Sandslash.
Alolan and Sandslash especially is so cute.
Sandshrew's cuter, though.
Yeah. Oh, we want... Oh, double fire choice beginning is bad for us. Let's see. We want to go down...
Well, we've got a Flareon or a Blaziken are the two Pokemon.
Yeah, left root is our best choice to start.
Cool, so Flareon.
Yeah, left root definitely best choice. I was just taking a moment to think about that one. Because
mm-hmm.
left root gets his Flareon, then we want to go right for ground, because ground's super effective.
It also doesn't matter, I don't think, what Alpax picks, because I'll get the NPC vote with me, and then you vote, so we'll always have a three vote.
Yeah, Alpax can spam this time, so we coordinate.
I would be shooketh if I got another shiny Flareon. So... And the only shiny, the only shiny I've actually got from these is a shiny Flareon.
Look at Pinkurchin. Look how cute he is.
Pinkurchin is nice.
Look at his little zappy face. Right, now I just blast it with Hydro Pump because.
Well, I have the Dynamax thing, but I can't do shit to it, so.
Yeah. You have a Togetic, yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Ooh, Reflect setup is alright. Just depends whether or not it's got more physical or special moves. Swords Dance is a plus two, so that's good. You know, I recently found out how Pokemon stats work, and it's really weird. So, the way it works is... Oh, God. All stats start as a fraction of 2 over 2, right? And then if your stat goes up, you increase the top number by the number. So plus 1 makes it a 3 over 2. And a 4 over 2, etc. And then a minus 1 will do it on the bottom thing, but will negate first, then do it. It's a really weird thing. I was like, oh, I assumed it was just like a straight multiplier, but it's not.
I don't even understand what.
It's just, rather, it's a percentage increase, but it's done via fractions rather than a multiplication.
Sure, okay, it's a bit weird.
Yeah.
Just seems like an overly convoluted way to do it.
Yeah. Look at him.
He's cute.
I love Pinkurchin. I also just love his name. Like, Pinkurchin is perfect. Yeah, sure, whatever fire is. Like, it's a really interesting choice, but it sucks for you because you are an ice steel type, which means you are doubly weak to fire, and if that thing sneezes on you, you go down, boy. Alright, play rough.
It's about all I've got. I'm a bit shit against this Flareon, honestly.
The problem was that we had a bad starting matchup of Fire.
Mm-hmm.
Flareon didn't have fire moves. They buff Flareon like in one of the generations.
It
really
doing
good.
A shadow move, I think, is what he's thinking.
Yeah, it's spamming Shadow Ball. Which does mean, by the way, it has a ghost move, which means it's good against the boss. Because the boss we're fighting is...
So one of us could take this.
Yeah. I shouldn't take it. I should also stop potentially using... It's just used another ghost move. This is funny
how
as hell.
How bizarre.
We want either Alpax or the NPC to take this, because we don't want the NPC to have... the...
Oh!
You have a rock move, dude.
Yeah, but he used
Love
Swords
it.
Dance.
That's an ugly spike. Excuse me, Pinkurchin is adorable! He's got his little butt mouth and everything. He does have a little butt mouth.
Feed it to the Flareon. Oh,
no.
Dear. No, no, no.
And it's
He's
called,
spiky.
And it's an urchin, and it's called Pincurchin, like Pincushion. And I think that's adorable.
I love you, Ian. You've got such manic energy about such random things.
I remember when it was alive. Lol. No, it died. Hey, Tofu.
The Sandslash really did a number on it.
Sandslash decided to just destroy that. Sandslash went, that one, fuck it. So Blacephalon is an interesting
one.
So who,
if anyone wants to take this?
Alpax probably, so we get the Shadow Ball on our team. Either Alpax or we want to hope Ivy takes it, I'd say. I'm fine. I just need to use some Thunder or Venom Drenches in the next couple of fights.
I'm going to keep Togetic as long as I can because I have a heal.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure. And then
well,
Ivy didn't take it. God damn
it.
I
think we made a mistake there.
We should still
I think
be,
I maybe should have taken it in that case.
We should still be okay and we go ground here. Because that's a Sandslash.
Excellent.
So Sandslash squad. Alpax will replace Sandslash with Sandslash. But this will have ground type moves which are going to be super effective against Blacephalon.
Yeah.
Blacephalon is an interesting one because like I was reading up on some of the competitive Pokemon recently and it is not competitive in singles but it is potentially usable in doubles in a really stupid build that I want to try where Blacephalon has a special move that's unique to it that deals damage to everything but deals 50% of its own health to itself. Now, so if you use two of it, it dies. But there's a low-key suicide bomber build you can build with it, which you use Oranguru to boost to... Oranguru has a move called Instruct, which lets the same Pokemon act twice and remove. I use it a lot in this mode. The play is you get one, give it Citrus Berry, which heals when it gets to 50%, get it to deal 50% of its own health, heals up, and then you just get it to do it again. And I really want to try it. I super duper want to try Blacephalon Suicide Bomber.
I know you do.
It looks like fun.
Mainly because Oranguru is involved and you love Oranguru.
I really do love Oranguru. It's one of my favourite Pokemon. They're cute. You've got a big monkey.
Also, Ice Boy versus actual Sand Boy.
Ow. This is actually really cool to look at, just a double Sandslash.
Yeah.
I prefer a Alolan Sandslash, I have to say.
Fair enough. I like both of them, to be honest.
Both are really cute, though. Max Hailstorm. Drop it like it's hot. This should do a chunk.
It was a semi-decent chunk.
Mm-hmm. Problem is, I only have one attacking move on this thing, and it's the move that I would use to hit the Cephalon if I get this dude all the way up. Hey, I get healed. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Life Juice is so good.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I had to eat a turn there because I don't have much against this. I only have one attacking move that can hit, and it's Hydro Pump. Do you want? Let's play a game. Alpax, we're going to boost one of your random stats by two. Let's go, girls. Unless this is targeted at me, in which case I'm doing shit all.
Ouch.
Yep. It's fine. He's all right.
Maybe we should have done a life dew.
Maybe. Special Defense Rising's fine. Alpax is using a physical attacker, so that's not going to defense too much against him.
Slowly getting there.
We're chunking slow. Play rough. Does damage.
Yeah, I may as well just use Life Juice.
Come on, attack up. Attack up, randomize.
Nope.
It's fine. We're get fine team physical attacker, which means that Alpax now takes less damage. Which is something.
Mm-hmm.
And we get our Cryogonal back, which means we're either going to take another death, or we're going to get a second attack, Ice Attack in there.
Which will be very, very useful.
Yep. I'm going to sit here and buff Alpax the entire fight. It's very entertaining to me. Nice, there
Yay.
We go. That's what we wanted to see.
Okay, so this should get it, right?
That should be KO. Kaboom. Alright.
I am thirsty.
Do I go eat water?
Thank you.
And Yeetus. Biggest Yeetus.
Biggest Yeetus?
Yep. Stonk. I wonder if I'll catch it.
Also, this is a stupid thing. Do we still have bits on our account?
Should do.
Because if we don't, how are we giving them to Octo?
I'll buy someone's tomorrow stream.
Well, it's just we can't do it from the app because the expensey. So who wants this? Not Alpax.
Alpax hasn't taken it. Then we either have to gamble on Ivy taking it or one of us takes it.
I've got the heal, so it might be better for you to take it.
Because Stomping Tantrum and Stone Edge are both going to be good against Blacephalon.
Yeah.
I mean, Alpax can be Sand Slash buddies.
That's nice.
Yeah. Let's see. Grass, Psychic, Electric.
There's Elder Goss in the middle, I think.
We don't want the middle. That's the only one that's bad. In fact, right is bad. Left is bad too. We want right. Right. Psychic. Left is a Magneton. So it's weak to fire. And also, this gives us one more random chance of potentially getting Ivy to get rid of Cryogonal before we fight a fire type.
Fair.
All right. What have we got? Claydol's ground type as well. This worked out really well for us.
Nice. So they might take this one.
Maybe.
Unless we want to keep their life due. Look at Sandslash buddies. They look great on my screen.
Sandslash squad is great. I'm into it. Okay. Cryogonal's reflect.
That's nice. Sets us up.
Well. Unfortunately... Oh, it did use a physical move. Cool.
Ow.
No, wait. That's special. Claydol's special attacking, so it shouldn't do too much for that, but I'm liking Sword Sense setup.
You do it too.
Hmm?
You do it
I
too.
Don't have it.
Aw. That would have been funny though. Nice.
I got Leech Life though. Sandslash got thick thighs.
Yeah, he do.
Like, kind of thick though.
Love you.
Love you too.
Do I go beak?
I mean, do you
probably
have
not.
Do you have anything good for it?
No.
Then if you pass the puck, it goes to me, so I can dive into Max Leech Life.
Yeah, go for it.
Probably go for it. Got you on mute, but need to shame Lou for being the worst game. No idea who Posh Spice is. Then I said Victoria Beckham, and he seriously asked, is that another Spice Girl? Raging.
Is he even gay?
Is he even gay? That's hilarious.
He's straight, boy.
I love you.
Well, she can't hear us,
no.
So I'm typing back to her.
She better not spoil anything about Bake Off, because the Bake Off is the finale tonight, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we got
the
finale to watch tomorrow. I'm hype. I have every part of me believes.
It's going to be Peter.
I'm half expecting everyone so of the three finalists,
you
one of them
want it to be
doesn't deserve to be there.
Laura.
And she gets there every week because the other people fuck up. One other person fucks off, and she always just survives. I genuinely think.
Fuck you, Claydol.
I genuinely think that Laura's going to take it because someone else is going to fuck up. I think the other two are going to mess up something and she's going to sneak it. I can't believe Hermine's not in the final though.
Yeah, I think a lot of people were upset about
After Lottie went out, I was convinced Hermine was going to be the winner.
I kind of like Claydol, you know.
Claydol is nice. I just think he's neat.
I am very much just healing myself at the minute, just so you know.
That's fine.
I don't do a lot of damage to him anyway.
No, you picked a support Pokemon, like.
Didn't you want a Dynamax?
I forgot to.
Well, enjoy
because
our
I was talking to because TSP came in and distracted me.
Fair.
Big icy boy.
I like him. Where's his mouth?
They don't have one. They have no mouth. They must scream.
That's weird.
They didn't really use. Did it do that?
Yeah. It did. Oh, not me! 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 Not me!
They get full health. That's our second takedown of the raid, isn't it?
Yeah, but I'm taking Claydol. So I didn't want to die.
Fair.
And I had a heal lined up.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, babe. Right, which was... And that will kill.
Hopefully.
I'm enjoying that... So close, but let's get a real Pokemon Master in here to finish this.
Oh my god, stop. Oh, it got rid of the Sandstorm.
Oh, there we go. That's how you do. That's how. That's what skill does.
Yeah, big sand slash did all the work. You just hit tiny sand slash came in like.
Just like yeah. So we got this to take. We got this as a choice, and we also have the scientist on the other side, which will give a random Pokemon.
Hmm.
Again, Ivy getting rid of hers is probably a big choice, a big thing for us. We're up against special attacker, so her wasting a turn using reflect didn't do anything for us. It, cool. It hasn't shown that it has light screen. I'm keeping my Sandslash.
Fair. The size of Sandslash doesn't matter. What matters is having a Sandslash. We need another Sandslash, lads.
So if you're taking this, we have to hope that Ivy randomizes on the other side. I feel like Alpax is too in love with his Sandslash.
Oh yeah, no. Sandslash boys can't.
No. This point where he betrays me and takes Sandslash. Come on, Ivy didn't take it.
Fucking
well,
hell.
We're going into the Fire Legendary with two Pokemon weak to fire. And this thing has a very high-powered AoE attack that can just fucking wreck us. Let's go, girls! Blam, blam, banana.
Blam, blam.
There he is. There's the gay clown himself.
He's awful.
Okay. I love it. I actually think it's a great design.
I know you do. I have super effect. Whoever is before me, if you don't have super effective.
What do you have?
I have Trick Room.
I don't. We don't want that because we've got two very fast Pokemon.
I've got Ancient Power.
Yeah, Ancient Power is fine. Fire Blast.
But I don't have very many PP.
Apparently, it's faster.
Well,
than
that's
this.
An opening move. Shall I use Trick Room then?
I don't. No, we just have to hope we last because the fact that it's got a Beast Boost with Special Attack up means it can pretty much one shot. We just need to hope we kill this fast. Sword Dance. That's fine.
I'll thingy then. I'll
Dynamax. It's not super worth it for like your attacks. What it is worth it for is a chance for you to get hit. Because if it hits you, you have a chance to like tank a shot. I see Stone Edge again. Like Stone Edge is known as Stone Miss because it has a very low accuracy.
Do we want the Sandstorm though?
Yeah, the Sandstorm will be fine. Me and Alpax are immune to it.
Okay.
Ground and steel moves aren't hit by it. Fledgling, hello, how are you doing?
Fledgling, hi.
If you stick around for a little bit, we're gonna dump you on the other on your other
Yeah, so Fledge, we're finishing off this raid and then we are raiding. We're gonna raid Octo at the end of the stream.
But how are you feeling, man?
Yeah,
obviously
how
last
you doing?
Night you weren't feeling too great.
I see Yo with an exclamation mark and I think of Yo Sushi.
That's it, that's game.
And it makes me sad. Oh my god, we got wrecked by the jester.
We got wrecked by the gay clown. And he kicks us out.
He's like, see you later, lads. Aw, that was a shame.
Wow.
I blame Luke.
I blame the Ice Steel type going into Fire Pokemon.
Flareon, Sandslash.
Baron yesterday. That's good.
No shinies here.
No shinies here.
I'll take the Sandslash.
Remember to check your Flareons because they can be bad.
It definitely wasn't. It was orange. But yeah, Flareon is like a very slightly paler orangey-yellow colour when normal Flareon is just orange. Better than yesterday, but still not great, I'm guessing.
I'm glad to hear better, at least. So, we owe Octo some change.
We owe Octo like a quid.
Yep. This came from Octo as you had an error of doubles with him. Oh, nice.
Oh, cool.
We're sending
and
you.
And then we're sending you back.
Sending you straight back. So, for those who aren't aware, we owe Octo £1. Well, sorry, 101 bits in change. So
yesterday.
From last night's stream where he donated us 600, where he meant to donate us 499. So we're
so
going
funny.
To go raid Octo.
And give his bits back.
And give his bits back. So I'm now going to do the awkward bit where I stand up.
So right. You'll see us on Thursday for Animal Crossing. That's our next stream. We'll just do a quick chill, and then we'll get you over. And then, of course, Saturday for Fire Emblem.
Absolutely.
We're getting real close to that 300 now, and I'm so excited about it. So thank you, everyone, for coming. If you want to say a quick hi to Octo, that's where we're sending you. That's so funny that we're sending Fledge straight back.
I do actually think that's hilarious that we're just firing right to his other person.
So is it going?
Should be.
Right, we should be on the way, lads, so I'll say bye now, just in case it cuts us off before we get to.